Hi-oh!
Alright, and we're on. What's up, boys? It's been a fucking minute.
Yeah, it has.
Fucking assholes, Jesus Christ. Fucking gigging and shit all the time, huh?
Yeah, well, you know.
Oh, I gotta make money playing the guitar!
Yeah.
That's what you sound like.
That's my
impression of you.
That's about right.
What's going on in y'all's fucking world?
Nothing. I just got my mind blown by a show that's about to happen tomorrow night
at
Gun Lake Casino.
Oh, the Queen show?
No. That. I mean, if I were down in Texas, I'd go to the F1 race and watch Queen, but...
What's going on with Queen?
Queen is playing the Formula One race tomorrow.
No shit.
Yeah, with the Killers.
Wild.
Which is hilarious.
So they got some substitute.
Are Adam Lambert from the United
Adam
States?
Adam Lambert's still singing for him.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
What?
Adam Lambert's from the U.S., right? The Killer's not.
Yes, Adam Lambert is American.
Yeah, he's the only American of the whole lineup for the F1 race. Except Logan Sargent, who is...
Is F1 racing not, like, American? What?
I'm
not up on fucking...
It's mostly not.
I think it's big in Europe and Italy and shit.
I mean, it's getting bigger here now that Netflix did its whole thing.
Oh, it's trash. Yeah, okay, it's that shit. Yeah.
I watched a couple episodes of that show. It's pretty.
It's a great show.
I'm impressed you only watched a couple episodes.
Yeah, right? It does suck you back into it. But
you guys are fucking into that shit, man. The fucking little cars, little fast cars.
Yep.
Shit, yeah, it's kind of your fucking jam, isn't it?
Yup.
All Mini Coupes.
Yep.
You still got the Mini Cooper?
Yeah, it's in the driveway.
Oh, nice. Hell yeah, I want to check it out before guys roll. I'm gonna fucking drive it after the podcast, drunk off my fucking ass.
Sounds perfect.
We're fucking no headlights.
E-brake
all the headlights, because there's at least four of them.
I've got six.
Six
headlights.
Nice.
Four. Yeah, two of the swirl fog lights.
Headlights are for pussies. Yeah. I'm not really into brakes either. You know,
there's only one brake, and it's the emergency one.
That's right. Yeah, goddamn right. I got a parking brake. That's it. Yeah. Son.
Just drifting around like a boss.
Hitting
that e brake.
That's the idea.
Yeah, no, I'm not super following the fucking F1 shit or whatever. It's not really my jam. I hear it's fucking that show was intense though.
It gets pretty intense. There's a lot of politics involved in with it.
That whole world,
it's so wild, the difference between that and like NASCAR, because NASCAR is so fucking white trash
for sure.
Like nothing against people that like it, but
it's
inherently the culture. And then
this weekend is Texas, which is very NASCAR-esque. There's a whole big parking lot full of RVs and shit like that. Mm-hmm. Just like you'd see in an F1 race.
I can imagine.
Like you would see in a NASCAR race. But when you have, like, we have Vegas and Miami this year, and those are both just super high class of shit. Like, you can't get in there with less than $10,000 a day
for admission.
You know,
fuck that.
You guys ever fucking go to like NASCAR races and shit like that?
I've been to an Indy race. I've never been to an F1 or a NASCAR race.
There's like a couple of tracks around here. The one on 131 or whatever is NASCAR, right? They only do like one or two races a year.
Yeah, they do stock car racing.
I've got a Ford Flex sitting in my parents' driveway that I'm going to bring to the next demolition derby.
Let's do it, or something like that.
Just demolish.
Let's we'll sponsor your car, dude. We'll do a Dangerville. I do like vinyl graphics and shit. I'll cut fucking Dangerville graphics and we'll fucking put it on the car 100%. For you.
100%.
That would be huge.
Help you with the entry fee. That's the fucking, that's the sponsorship, right?
So
let's do it, dude.
Yeah, I got five on it, bro.
We'll come, I got five on it. For sure. I'm not even joking, dude. Let's do that. It'll be fucking hilarious.
I'm not joking.
Yeah.
I went to a demolition derby one time, and it was a fucking blast, man.
Let's
it was a
go.
BYOB situation. We're just rolling in there with a massive
holy
cooler.
Shit.
Getting fucking
my cat just hit every fucking thing.
So much cat
on
ass on that board right now.
I've never experienced anything like that. Jesus Christ. Fucking cat. Sorry about that. We're fighting this huge fucking battle with the cats fucking around here, dude. That's a goddamn shit show. You guys got cats?
I do.
Yeah.
He's got the coolest cat.
I have a Maine Coon. He's a badass.
Ooh, I want a Maine Coon, dude.
His name is Nigel Thornberry.
my brother and mom were just talking. I didn't know what the fuck these things were. Yeah, and I pulled up a picture, dude. I'm not Maine a big cat person. Shit, I'm getting a Maine Coon fucking cat. Yeah. Dude.
Plus, they act like dogs.
Is it enormous?
Like, how big is it? 18 pounds.
Okay. Yeah.
So he's probably about up to the size of this coffee table.
That's not super heavy.
He's not huge. Yeah. He's small for a Maine Coon.
Right. That seems, yeah.
Some of those things, I don't know if the photos were doctored, but they had them like up on their hind legs and they're like as tall as people.
They can get
they're crazy. Fucking gigantic. Yeah.
And they're friendly. They don't like eat your face.
Nope. They're friendly. They're lazy. They're...
No, they eat your face. All cats eat your face, first of all. It doesn't matter. You die, they're going to eat your face.
Yeah, that's a thing. I watched a whole...
Oh, yeah, like, your face is
like,
eaten, dude.
You've got like 3 days until the cat completely makes you
they don't give a fuck, dude. Yeah. My fucking... it's actually my boss, but he... It's kind of a long story, but he was in the fucking game for a while of fucking... they're like cat breeding, but they're like two levels down from being like a wild cat. So they're like F1, F2, F3. It's like the generational gap or whatever is the way they fucking label it or whatever the fuck.
Talking about races again.
So like, yeah, right. That's what they fucking, I'm pretty sure that's what they call them though, is F1 or something. And I don't know what the fuck that means, but like, so he was like fucking,
Formula 3 cats.
I know, but not with the cats, I mean, dude. Fucking, but they were like right
handling
two levels below
such,
like a fucking leopard, dude. You know, like two generations from a leopard. Jesus. They're like fucking cats, dude. And like he was like selling them all over the country and like the fucking like pro football players and shit buying them and shit, like thousands of dollars.
That's
and shit.
Wild,
yeah, man. It was a lot. It was pretty fucking wild.
I feel like he might have misinterpreted the story. Boss is like, no, I'm selling pussy. And he's like, oh,
fucking cats.
Dude, awesome, dude. Man. Super indeed. Cool.
Well, I do his marketing, so I'm pretty sure I would have known.
I've got raccoons.
Do you know?
Like, he's Maine Coon over there.
Yeah.
Raccoons.
Yeah, you got fucking trash pandas.
They live in my porch. It's cool.
That's cool. You feeding them and shit?
Accidentally.
They're getting in your trash.
Well, he tries to feed the West Side Stray and feeds the raccoons instead.
Yeah, exactly.
The West Side Stray. That's my new rap name, dude.
West Side Stray.
That's pretty huge.
Yo, they call me West Side Stray, son. That's actually a pretty dope rap name. Hey, can I fucking tell you guys real quick my fucking rapper story here, which I've been meaning to tell for like fucking 3 weeks since I saw the Peter Gabriel show. You guys Peter Gabriel fans?
Sure.
Bro, Peter Gabriel's the fucking best in the world. If you're not listening to the new Peter Gabriel, you're fucking missing life right now. So we go to the show, okay? And the CD's sitting right here. I haven't had a chance to tell you. It was about a month ago. We're fucking walking to the show. There's everything down there. When's the last time you've been to Detroit? But, you know, like, everything's right in the same spot. So yeah. the stadium, so all the sports teams, everything. So there's a Tigers game going on. The Peter Gabriel show is happening. So it's, like, huge amounts of people, right? It's, like, Cabrera's fucking last game or something. So it's, like, huge weekend, right? Everybody's there. We're walking back from dinner, fucking drunk as fuck, getting to the show, you know, which is at Little Caesars.
Sure.
And this fucking dude is out there fucking, he's on a bike and he fucking pedals right up to me. Like I'm the fucking mark. Okay. And he goes, "Hey, what's up, Matrix?" And because I'm wearing like a black, like, just like a, like, it's that thing I wear, but it's not like long. It's not like a trench coat or nothing, but it's just a black, like, sweatshirt thing with a zipper on it, right? So for some reason, that's Matrix. So I'm already like, I'm laughing already, you know? And he's like, "Hey, what's up, man? Whatever, you like music, blah, blah, right?" And I'm like, "Yeah, what's up?" You know, like, I'm fucking like kind of talking shit back to him, you know, because I'm already fucking laughing my ass off about, like, I can't wait to tell this story. So he's fucking starts hitting me up like, "Yeah, I'm a fucking rapper. You know, like, what?" And I'm like, "You fucking good? You any good?" I'm like fucking like breaking his balls right back to him. I'm like, "You know, I'm pretty good, man. You any fucking good?" I'm like, "You gonna be the new fucking Dr. Dre? Like, what you got?" You know, like really talking shit back to him. And he's holding his own and he's like, "Yeah, man, I fucking, this is me, I'm rapping about science and shit." And I'm like, "All right, I'm into that. Like, what's up?" And and he goes like, he's like, "Yeah, here's my CD." And I'm like, "Yo, you're selling CDs?" I'm like, "All right, man, I got a dollar on that CD for you, son." And he's like, "Yo, can I get $2? I go, "All right,
it's a better move on his part. Yeah.
You doubled your money, man." Yep. So I'm like, "All right, I got you $2. So I fucking give him the fucking $2. And so here's the CD anyway, which To be fair, the artwork's pretty dope. I don't know what this is. Some kind of crazy demon or something on here. Fucking,
Gotta respect this guy printing and selling CDs. That's
why. Signed. Oh, it's fucking signed copy. Like, I don't know what they got the song names. It's just some of these song names. Helium 3, the same song. UAP UFO. Abstratosphere. Citizen Scientist Movement.
I'm gonna allow this guy already.
I was allowing it for sure. Neutrinos. Okay. Thin Pipeline, Handle Truth, and Bioprinting. But like, I cannot figure out who this guy is. Like, he doesn't like, but there's nothing on the CD.
If you listen to it,
fuck yeah,
he's gotta say his name.
Bro, I threw
what
it
rapper
in.
Rapper doesn't have his
right.
It is just
it's Neil
terrible.
deGrasse Mike Tyson.
So we fucking throw it in on the way home. You know, we're fucking baked as hell, just laughing our asses off. It is pretty goddamn terrible. I could not fucking find the dude's like name or whatever. I'm like, I gotta get this guy fucking on the pod. Immediately, like, this guy is where it's at. But no, it's pretty terrible.
Yeah, the CDR might have been the first indication. Yeah, the guy's not exactly a top tier.
CDR, no label on it.
Was
at
it
all.
An older guy?
He's like a young guy, whatever. Okay. Little, probably younger than us, fucking dreaded out, fucking riding around a little BMX bike.
That's no, at least bring yourself into the early 2000s and light scribe that CDR.
There's no, like, didn't come with a card or anything that says,
nothing,
follow
dude.
Me on Instagram.
Nothing, dude. Nothing. Man. That's what I was saying. I'm like, bro, you're down here hawking your shit. You ain't even fucking put your goddamn name on it. And shit, you
that's
know?
A guy like, who knows his place in life. He's like, yeah, I ain't going nowhere, brother. Like,
let's make a few
give
bucks.
Me $2, catch a shit, never listen to it again.
Yeah, it was pretty painful. We threw it in and fucking rocked it on the way home, and it's just like the worst kind of fucking, you know, bad production and shitty mumble
rap.
Still
probably better than Kendrick Lamar.
Well, I mean, that don't take a lot, dude. Let's be honest. Shit on Kendrick Lamar.
Should have came right back in and be like, check out this Frosty Boy shit right here.
I know. I should have fucking gave it to him. Like, yo, talking about the return of Frosty Boy here.
You should have just turned the tables on me. Like, dude, I'm going to need $10 right now. I'll hook you up with this shit right now.
Yeah, it was a lot. It was pretty gold, though.
That's a great plan. Oh, yeah, I'll buy your CD for $2, but you have to buy mine for $10.
Right? Yeah, man, it's fucking, you know, what's it worth?
And you don't even have a CD. Send him a link.
That's right, yeah. It's the QR code, son. Fucking download that shit.
It's a Frosty Boy coupon.
That's right. That's what I should fucking do is have the fucking download QR code on the fucking
thing. Have you ever gotten choice albums that way, rock, rap, or otherwise? Like, has anybody ever sell you some shit off the street? It's like, whoa, these guys are awesome.
No. Not that I can think
not even
of.
Once.
No, yeah. Yeah, I've tried to, like, you know, support like I did with this guy. Like, yeah, all right, let's fucking hear it, you know? But
I think we talked about this one time before, and maybe I'm making this up in my head. Yeah. I could have sworn one of the times we went to Chicago, or maybe you were down there separately or something, I thought that was how we came across that bus driver dude back in the day. Is that not a thing?
No, I heard about thing. Bus driver from fucking, I was into it with fucking Sean from Holloway. We were like really into like underground hip hop shit. He was really into it. We were fucking smoking a lot and shit, fucking hanging out, listening to fucking you know, mixtapes and shit like that of fucking underground hip hop. But yeah,
that's hilarious. Bus driver stuff, you know?
Yeah.
Looking longingly into each other's eyes, bumping some mixtapes. That's well played.
No, we got the, we went and saw Tool in Chicago and the fucking, this fucking monk dude, you guys know what the Bhagavad Gita is or whatever, like the book. It's like the holy book of Buddhism or whatever, right? So we're fucking like our stoner asses were whatever. We're fucking 20 maybe.
Same thing, you know, close enough.
2 billion people.
Yeah. So we're fucking walking. Do you remember this? We were like at a Red Robin.
I still
Robin.
Have mine and I'm meaning to read it. Yeah.
We're at like a Red Robin in like the airport parking lot or something, like down in beers. We fucking walk out and this dude comes up to us and he's like, have you guys read the Bhagavad Gita? And we're like, what? And he's fucking, you remember he's like, yeah, I'm a monk. He's like some fucking like white dude wearing like, like just dressed like shit, you know, or whatever. And we're like, what the fuck? And he's like giving away like copies of this book or whatever, but with the intention of that, like, you're supposed to like tip him for it or whatever, you know, like pay him for it or something, doing that whole fucking scam. But we were so fucking young and stupid, like we didn't know. We were like, oh sweet, thanks for the book.
I didn't pay him one bit. I'm just like, thanks, bro.
Like we're like going to the tool show, like, ah, fucking hell yeah.
I read this immediately. Take it easy, dude. You're
sitting, have a good one. Yeah. Sitting in the stands at Tool. Like, why do these lyrics match up with
right now? This is literally the song. Yeah, it was fucking wild. So that's anyway, hilarious. Yeah, you still got your copy of that. Oh, yeah, I still got my copy of it too.
I want to read it, dude. It seems like pretty fucking interesting shit.
It's over in the, I think it may be in the other, I don't know where it is, but no, it's terrible.
Got to spread the word, spread the gospel.
Spreading the gospel of, yeah.
Rocking an Adidas t-shirt for some reason. It's like,
it's like you're just a homeless person.
You don't seem monk-like at all.
All day I dream about Siddhartha.
Yes.
And I had to unhook it because the goddamn cat.
Oh, I know.
Fucking goddamn it. You son of a bitch.
Gotta hook that shit back up. You gotta roll the dice with that cat.
Booyah! Right.
Hooking it back up. Hold on.
We can do our own sound effects.
Wait for it. Oh, Jesus Christ.
This is good podcasting right here.
Yep.
How do you hook up the USB?
What is USB?
As I was saying previously.
Hey now. There it is. Yeah, you got it. Hey now. It's back, baby. Fuck's going on with you fools, man? Fucking, like I said, he's gigging all the time, it seems like.
Yep. Just trying to gig as much as we can.
Playing all those Goo Goo Dolls covers and whatever. What the fuck you guys
playing?
We
haven't played Goo Goo Dolls in like a month.
Like a month.
That's saying something, yeah.
Talking about Baby's Black Balloon. You guys ever do that song, dude? That was our jam. We used to play that one way back in the day when we were 14.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's a good song, actually. I was fucking going through, well, I was fucking telling him, kind of a long story, boys, but I fucking, back in the day, my CD collection got stolen out of my car. Have I told you guys that story? I've told it on here a couple times. And fucking,
seems familiar. Yeah, I think everybody's CD collection has been stolen out of their car.
Right. Was it one of the 300 booklets?
Yeah, and it's like all my fucking favorite CDs. So fucking, this is like 10 plus years ago now. And that was when it was the iPod era, so that was when I switched to iPod, but like I kept all the cases because like I just fucking couldn't.
I used to keep all the album art in with the sleeves and shit.
That's a good move. Yeah, well fucking, so I still got all the art and everything, and like, I just couldn't bear to throw them away then, and like just now I had to get rid of them. It's like it's gotta go, you know, like so fucking I'm going through and I'm fucking like literally like sitting there fucking like with a single tear and another tear, like looking at fucking each album, like, and I'm going through like artwork and shit because like you don't see the artwork enough anymore. So I'm like rolling through some of my favorite records and like a bunch of obscure shit from way back in the day that you can't get anymore.
That Jewel record that you just couldn't put down.
Hey, I'm down with some Jewel, dude. No,
barely got
around,
my
dude.
Dish wallet.
Found shit like, do you guys know Reggie and the Full Effects?
Fuck yeah.
Yeah. So like I had like an original copy, a promotional copy. Like you can't buy that shit anymore. No. Get Up Kids, any of that shit. Like
Abe Diasmill, the Glass Jaw record.
Yeah.
I had one of the originals of that from there. They had a tour that had a special promo version.
Right.
Of that.
That's the kind of shit I'm talking about.
For
like,
sure.
That's the shit that's really
not to
painful.
Mention all the local shit.
Yeah, local shit. Yeah. Man. Yeah.
All those like local albums that you bought that you can't get.
Yeah.
You can't get that shit anywhere.
Including
anymore. You can't
the
get
Papa
the digital
Vegas
copies
record.
Of that shit anymore.
I found the Papa Vegas record, you know.
The original prints of that guy's album.
I bought an Adele record from Target like 4 times because you could only get 2 Adele songs on the Target version.
Oh, that was the Take Off Your Pants and Jacket. 3 different versions of that. The Blink-182 album.
Well, that's not Adele, but totally.
Wait, that's not Adele? That's different? Like, if you guys probably don't know, but fucking the original prints of the Tool record Anima, there's a misprint on the back, so like for collectors of such Tool shit, so like shit like that, the original Mars Volta EP that you can't get anywhere at all anymore, like before De Laos in the Comatorium, I had that.
I mean iTunes, but
it's no
outside
it's,
of that.
No, it's not on iTunes. That's what I'm saying.
Not.
You can't
listen
to it. Yes.
Just like those 2 Adele tracks.
Yeah, you can't get them anywhere else. No. Yeah. So anyway, fucking, I don't even remember where the fuck I was going with this, but fucking, that was a painful experience that I fucking finally threw away all those fucking old CDs. And my other big takeaway is I have incredible taste in music. Just seriously, just
good for you.
Just the best, man. Jesus Christ, it's so good. Every record, I was like, oh, this record owns. And because the shit that got stolen was all the shit that was in my car, which was like my favorite shit, the shit I wanted to actually listen to. So I was just like, oh man, this record rules. God damn it, it is on there. That's good. That's good. Okay, that's good. But I had that shit on CD, which you can't fucking get anymore.
Anyway. I still bump my CDs. I'm not going to lie. I'm the only human being on the planet still throwing the
I don't think I'd have got away from them if fucking my shit didn't got stolen.
I'm dreading having
still
to buy
be
that,
collecting.
That next car without the cars CD that don't player, have them anymore.
Yeah, yeah, man. Yep. Oof. It's brutal.
Mini something Cooper about life, man. Mini's still got a CD player in it.
Not that you use it for anything except to hold up your phone.
Yeah, it's I have a phone. A phone thing connects right into my CD.
It's gonna
slot.
Be. You remember the fucking like you'd have a CD player with a tape deck.
Fuck
thing
yeah!
Oh, yeah,
well, now it's gonna be the next thing. They gotta have fucking like a CD player. Like you got your Walkman, but it just plugs in with an aux cable or something into your shit. Really? I'm sure they got that right.
I
gotta. That's
imagine,
what you're gonna have to do, dude.
Yeah,
you're gonna have to put the old fucking anti-skip
Velcro to the top
elevated
dashboard
from 96
talking 10 second shock absorption in there. That's where it's
fuck
at.
Yeah, dude,
my daughter will make you some sticky slime that'll just sit on your dashboard.
Yeah, baby,
you'll never skip.
That's where it's at.
Super absorbent and shit.
Oh, I got a dominant CD. I still occasionally will buy a CD now.
Yeah, dude.
You gotta
have it. I just bought the new fucking Peter Gabriel CD, mostly just to fucking like support the special edition or whatever, you know. It looks like he's got multiple mixes. He's putting out his shit with two separate mixes, which is a cool concept.
That's the thing that's happening a lot.
Yeah.
The new Prince album is doing that.
Okay, I can see that. Yeah,
he released like 70 tracks or something.
Right.
He's still alive.
The people trying to make money off of the Prince estate.
Yeah, the ghost of the artist formerly known as Prince, obviously.
He is truly the artist formerly known as Prince now.
the specter.
Indeed. Oh, that's cool. I haven't heard about that. What's going on with the new Prince shit?
He's got two live albums. Or something like that, and then the entirety of, I think it's the Cream album that's all re-recording or
remixes,
one takes or shit like that.
That when he died, they said that he has like several hundred songs finished that just like in his in the vault.
Yeah, that just didn't fit onto an album. Yeah.
700 terrible songs. Didn't make the cut.
Quite a few of them fucking.
I bet they probably are. Yeah, that's the same shit they did with Michael Jackson. They put out that fucking. Do you ever catch that?
I've heard everything about Michael Jackson.
Yeah, I really. I fucking love that
deep.
Album, dude. Yeah, that fucking After the Death album they put out of the new shit or whatever.
Yeah.
Yeah, I thought it was fucking great.
Legacy or something like that.
Yeah, and the fucking and they also put out on there the original versions that they used, which were also dominant. They were in some ways better, I thought, because it was like, I fucking love the late 80s, 90s production of this shit or whatever. Right. Like, you know, they stripped it all down and rebuilt it all up around the vocal and whatever. And those were fucking dope too, but it was, and they get picked like top producers to do that or whatever, you know. But it was like the originals are like equally cool, you know. I'm like, this is actually like better, you know. Like fucking, you ever hear Chicago, that song they fucking put on there? It's a fucking great song.
There's
man.
A Michael Jackson and Chicago song?
The song's called Chicago.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I thought it was
song.
The band Chicago.
I know, I got really excited for a second. Like,
that would have also
that
been dominant,
sure,
yeah.
Like real trumpet.
MJ Chicago Killet.
Yeah. Yeah, just check that. I forget what it's called, but there's like, it's eight songs or something. They got fucking Timberlake singing on one of them.
I know that one.
Yeah.
Yeah. The track after that is him and Akon, and it's the worst thing I've ever heard.
Okay. Yeah. Also fucking a new NSYNC out, boys. You catching this fucking action? NSYNC is everywhere right now. Everywhere.
They showed up at the VMAs, right?
Timberlake's got to get paid, dude.
Yeah.
His last album stunk, dude.
Everybody else had run out of money a long time ago.
Yeah,
dude.
But Joey's talking about the Man of the Woods album.
Yeah.
Timberlake's Man of the Woods. I really enjoyed that. It just wasn't a Timberlake album.
That's fair. I saw him on that tour at the Van Andel. It was fucking sweet. The song Montana, you know that one?
Probably. I've heard it for sure.
It's probably one of the best songs he's ever done. It's like track like 7 or 8. It's one of the big tentpole songs of that record. Mm-hmm. That song's fucking great, but there are some fucking not great songs on that record.
Those are probably the ones I like.
Yeah, maybe.
That sound like NSYNC.
No, I love NSYNC. None of this sounds like NSYNC. He's trying to go fucking country on this shit. I'm like,
he went country.
That album flopped. I'm not going to lie. It flopped across the board. And but the new NSYNC's pretty decent. It's fucking it's on the Trolls soundtrack. That's the whole thing. You know, he's doing that whole Trolls shit. And
new NSYNC song commands fucking your.
I thought it was pretty dominant. Dude, I liked it.
I was jamming out.
Talking about JC rules.
I know what I'm listening to on the break.
Yeah, talking about fucking others. The other guys. Talk about Lance Bass.
There's some kind of Chris in there. Chris something or other.
Chris Kirkpatrick. Get your ass kicked.
That's the only reason you know his name.
No. We were deep on that NSYNC train, dude. I still sing NSYNC songs. They're on my to sing playlist.
The story of us in middle school?
It's probably the same story as us in high school.
Did you guys dance?
What's the story?
Oh, yeah. Okay. We were all into
NSYNC. We danced, talent shows, and school dances and shit. We had choreography. Yeah.
Right. We did the thong song too.
Thong song was huge. Dude. Yeah,
oh, you guys had to be pulling some ass.
Bye bye bye. It was fucking.
Oh yeah.
We still do. We'll go to karaoke sometimes and do bye bye bye.
That's a great song.
And just you know, I don't know what this fucking means.
It means bye bye bye.
For the listeners, I'm squawking my hand across.
They all know what it is. Everybody knows what it is.
The Celebrity Album is a fucking masterpiece, gentlemen. You heard it here first.
The Game Is Over, dude. That's my favorite song.
I heard it in my head first 20 years ago when I was fucking listening.
I've always wanted to do a cover, like a metal cover of The Game Is Over. Do you guys know The Game Is Over?
Yes, absolutely.
Wouldn't it work as a metal cover?
I'm 100%
in. Yeah, let's do it, dude.
That's what we do now.
So good.
Segue. Look at that.
Yeah. No, I've heard the song 15 times.
15 yeah, every, for every remix that I've ever done of it.
The listeners don't know. Pod people.
Well, there's no listeners, so it doesn't really matter.
I'm just talking to you.
It's just, I'll be talking.
It's real if a tree falls situation.
Jake. When you listen to this in a couple of days, reminder, you make music.
All right, so what's the song? What's the song, fuckers? I didn't know it was a Post Malone cover.
Yeah.
Right? I was like, Jake, you wrote this? A good song, bro.
But you're...
No. No.
It's like, damn, dude.
Yeah, that's our new thing.
It's like, you got really good. And then turns out
we're doing pop punk or rock or whatever the fuck we feel like versions of other people's songs.
Yeah.
But better than them.
That's the idea. Anyways,
different. Let's say different.
Yeah, sure.
No, it was interesting. I did. It is a very cool version, first of all, and you guys should check it out. I enjoyed it right off the bat. And then
Chemical.
I didn't. It's a Post Malone song, Chemical, right?
Yeah.
And so I had never heard that song, and so it was interesting to me to hear that like way after the fact. I thought this was like like an original song.
I was curious to hear your thoughts, especially from somebody that hadn't heard the original song before.
I was like, oh, this is sweet, and then I heard the original, and I'm like, oh, okay, this is quite different, but still the same song, but it's still you know like totally makes sense. So. I'm not super up on Post Malone. I wish I was a little more.
I've heard a Post Malone song. Probably in passing somewhere. I couldn't pick a Post Malone sign on.
It's cool.
You can't be alive and an adult without having heard a Post Malone song.
I haven't,
dude.
I haven't, man. We're older than you guys.
A Post Malone song. I'm not saying that Post Malone song.
If you haven't turned on the radio in 10 years, then you
will. Which we have not.
Nope. That's crazy. Nope.
It's the last time I actually turned on radio.
I drive a Mini Cooper, so my radio doesn't work half the time. So...
What is that, a thing in the Mini Coopers?
Oh, it's everything fucking breaks in those stupid things.
Turns out they're huge pieces of shit.
Absolutely. Really small pieces of shit.
Yeah, right. Mini Cooper maximum problems.
Right.
Yeah,
right.
So...
That was their slogan.
They didn't have aux until, like, 2012. And since that was my last two cars, I had to listen to the radio a lot,
I couldn't tell you the last
time. Post Malone's on there.
I did catch I know there's a Weekend and Post Malone fucking joint they did together. I was catching that because I'm a fucking huge Weekend fucking Dick Gargler. So I like Post Malone. I think he's a cool guy.
Are you ready for the Weekend's new shit after he's no longer called the Weekend?
I don't know what he's doing here. This is a huge mistake on his fucking part. I think he's trying to be an actor with this fucking show that was stunk and flopped.
They canceled that shit after one season.
I don't know what he's doing here. This is a terrible idea from the Weekend.
Just going by Monday through Thursday.
Yo, I'm the work week now. Yeah, that's a terrible fucking call on his part, though. It stinks. The Weeknd, who I'm a huge supporter of in general, but that's a terrible idea. I don't. He's getting too big for his britches.
You spend all this fucking time and money to build up this brand and then bail on said brand for some Bush League name. It stinks. Stinks the Weeknd.
I don't know. Maybe I might be in the minority on this one, but I think that I'm personally just sick of hearing the Weeknd songs over and over and over and over and over.
Well, that might be, but what do you listen to the radio? That's what I'm saying.
The Weeknd is Michael Jackson since 2015.
Yeah, it's very Michael Jackson. And I mean, that's why it's fucking sweet.
Yeah.
You know, like his last record was fucking literally, I mean, I talked about it ad nauseum when it came out on here.
Spent many, many hours discussing the Weeknd album.
Huge fan. I still have. It was a fucking epic record. I went and saw him live too at fucking Ford Field.
That was probably pretty good.
Did you guys watch it? It's on HBO.
The concert?
Yeah. It's not the Ford Field show. It was like an LA show or something, but it's the same show. It was like 2 days later or something, but fucking awesome. You should definitely check it out. I mean, it's like dark, you know. That's what I love about it. It's fucking like he comes out in the Phantom of the Opera mask and the fucking city's on fire and shit. Like, it was fucking awesome.
Yeah, it's Michael Jackson on drugs.
It basically, really? Yeah.
And having sex.
Yeah, it's like, it's Michael Jackson not
with
gay.
Grown-ups.
Yeah, dude. Yeah, that you check out that fucking Weeknd show on you know, it's editing and stuff. It's but like, yeah, I caught it live. It was fucking huge.
Do you catch that Uncut Gems movie? It was like Adam Sandler movie. There's that whole Weeknd thread when he's just kind of starting out
as himself.
That's a fucking badass flick, and Weeknd's hilarious. And banging Sandler's
it's
girlfriend.
Fun movie. Yeah,
it's well worth a while. Oh, it's a legitimately good movie.
That I would watch just
Sandler
that.
As a serious actor. Like, he's made some fucking.
I don't know if I count that as like it's like serious, but it's also comical too. Like, it's not like his slapstick bullshit, but it's like, it's a serious movie, but it's like,
if you're putting it in a one camp or another, I mean, it's certainly more drama than comedy.
For this voice now.
Yeah, indeed. He'll never outgrow it.
I don't know, man.
He'll never outgrow it. Yeah, it's a good movie. You guys never caught Uncut Gems?
I did.
Yeah, okay.
I haven't seen it yet.
It's a lot to take in. It's a crazy movie, like hyper fast editing and like very like anxiety inducing, like fucking it's about a guy with a gambling addiction, basically, is more or less what it's about. It's an adult movie.
He's got some other flick where he's like a basketball scout. I think it's called Hustle or something, which is supposed to be really good. I haven't watched it yet, but it looks pretty choice.
Yeah, he's a good fucking actor. He should be by this fucking point. Right. You know, he's only made 20 goddamn movies or more or what?
20 a year.
Yeah, yeah. Did you guys see the one who was like they were doing like a fucking like Hateful Eight or whatever, like a Dirty Dozen or whatever. Yeah. What the fuck you call it, you know? Like,
It's the Magnificent Seven.
Magnificent Seven, but it was, some fucking play. I literally watched like 2 minutes of it. And I was like, no. It's like
that's
him
that
and
Western one, right?
Yes. Yeah. It is so terrible. It's fucking Rob Schneider and
all the standard
and
crew.
I'll allow,
it's your standard
I'll allow
Sandler
all
fare
those guys,
for sure.
But like, it was so bad. I was like, this is not happening.
It's kind of the dream. It's just like getting popular enough to allow your Bush League friends to be in all your shit.
Basically, if kinda we were doing we it, it would just be like, hey, you guys want to come in and like do the movie? Right. You know, like 100%, dude.
Nah, don't sleep on Schneider. Schneider's the man.
What was that, Brooklyn Nine-Nine? They had Sandler on there and Jake Peralta was like, oh, look, Adam Sandler's here, and he's like, oh, I'm a serious person, like I collect art, I'm writing a Russian flick.
He goes,
oh, seriously?
He goes, who does Kevin James play? And he goes,
Trotsky.
Yeah. He goes, he's like offended by it, and he's Trotsky. It's no, isn't it fucking Andy Sandberg?
Yeah,
is
Andy
the
Sandberg.
Yeah, he's the...
Is that, I don't remember if that was Brooklyn Nine-Nine or not, but it was whatever
Andy
Sandberg
was in it.
Yeah, I know
what you're talking about. Yeah.
Sandberg. I like that show quite a bit for a while. It kind of started to get a little too preachy towards the end. The first couple seasons of that show were pretty funny, actually. Yeah.
Never seen an episode.
It's The Office
either,
in a police station.
But I know it from
a
meme.
It's a good call. It's a good call.
Yeah. Do you guys ever see fucking... for some reason, we got to watch and the other weekend. We were fucking tracking this band here, and they got to fucking pulling up a bunch of old Andy Sandberg shit for unknown reasons. I have no idea why. But do you guys remember the fucking, I threw it on the ground?
Yes.
You guys remember?
Absolutely.
Dude, that, the whole weekend, that's all we were fucking doing was that material.
My kids kept doing that. The entire month of June, they threw it on the ground. Yeah. That was all they fucking did. For a whole month.
Which, to be fair, that's gold material on their part.
Got a birthday present. I said thank you, and I threw it on the ground. Just what?
Dude, it's so funny. My dad is not a cell phone. You remember? I don't know if you don't see it.
I wasn't a big Lonely Island, like Sandberg, like the comedy song shit.
You don't
even
like comedy songs?
Dick on a Boat or Dick in a Box.
Dick in a Box is great.
The movie.
Dick on a Boat, it's really about the same thing.
That's what I do. Okay. Did you guys see the movie, the Lonely Island, like, movie? I don't remember what it was called.
Superstar. Like
yeah,
like,
Never Stop Again.
I didn't see that.
That shit was pretty fun.
Ever since the day I was born, I was dope.
Yeah. I did see the one with him and fucking Jon Snow where they're tennis players. Did you guys catch that?
That was a funny fucking movie.
It's like a same thing, like a mockumentary where him and the guy who played Jon Snow are like.
Harrington?
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, they're fucking both like tennis stars or whatever, and they're like rivals, but like not. It's one of those things.
It's like the longest tennis match ever played.
It's
like a week long.
It's pretty fucking hilarious. I'm not gonna lie.
Kit Harington's the man to you, dude.
That Sandberg shit's pretty fucking funny. Some of it I kind of get where it's kind of like, all right, it's a little over the top, but like, dude, like watching that fucking going back to fucking 2010 when he was doing that, and I threw it on the ground. We were like in tears. It was like, this shit is so fucking funny, man. Fucking love it. Have to fucking go back through that shit. But that was the era of SNL that was like, I completely missed.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like,
I missed the last like 20 years.
Well, that's what I'm saying. Is everybody's got their era, and it kind of like, that by that point, I was out, you know? So
SNL is one of those things like music. We always talk about this where it's like it's in your formative years, like 15 to 20. That's your jam. And the same shit with SNL.
Yeah. Yeah.
Although objectively, I got to say, it was kind of like, it was
that was my
era.
Shit.
Yeah. Kate McKinnon.
Yeah.
Just, I think she just quit like last year, the year before.
Right.
I thought she was the funniest fucking thing I'd ever seen.
She was great.
I don't know what it was about her, but every time she walked on the fucking,
she was hilarious.
On the stage.
She did Hillary Clinton.
She was the funniest thing I'd ever seen. Yeah. She did.
Oh, yeah. She's good. That shit,
yeah.
She did the Aliens one too all the time.
Yeah.
Right?
The Alien one. That was hilarious. One of the funniest fucking things I've ever
I never
seen.
Caught that. Like the movie? Like doing Sigourney Weaver?
No. Like, that would they're in this like support group they're being interviewed for having had an alien abduction.
Oh, okay.
And everybody else was all like, the aliens brought me on board and they gave me hugs and they, you know, fed me really well. And she's like, oh, no.
Oh, my poot and my coop shoot were hanging out.
Nice. You guys fucking following any of this alien shit? Fucking Mexico and all that? And then
the guy from here.
Like
UAPs.
My homie here, fucking from the D.
UAPs or UFOs? Yeah, slash.
Who I would fucking shout out if he put his goddamn name on the fucking CD.
I saw the one, the alien they found in Mexico, but then I also saw a video like 2 days later that was like, is it cake?
Yeah, dude, it's so funny, dude.
So I don't know.
Is it cake shit, dude?
Is it cake?
Oh, that was the worst fucking, the worst paper mache aliens fucking I've ever seen, dude. Absolutely hilarious. Yeah. There's this shit on fucking Netflix, though. It's pretty good. It's Encounters.
I just watched.
Did you?
All five episodes in one fucking day.
Yeah, me too. I wish there was more. I hate, like, I get it at the same, it's like, there was only like four episodes or something. Yeah, and I was kind of like.
Yeah, I think it was only four.
Yeah, and it was like. I get it that like they're gonna put some, but like Unsolved Mysteries did the same thing. The new Unsolved Mysteries
three
is
fucking
like,
episodes.
And I'm like, come on, like what the fuck? Like,
there's
gotta
be more than three fucking Unsolved Mysteries.
Is that what the those are the remaining Unsolved Mysteries? Like, after that, like we got it pretty well notched at this point.
Yeah,
kind of got them all solved at this point. But is that Encounters thing? Is that like a Unsolved Mysteries? I haven't caught that yet.
Yeah, it's very similar to the new Unsolved Mysteries. It's a full on documentary, but it's very. It's very artsy, which
really,
I don't hate.
Really pretty drone shots, of absolutely fucking nothing.
Yeah, that sounds about right.
It's from fucking Amblin, Steven Spielberg's company.
Okay,
and so it's like it's really great, but that was my fucking thing about it was like these episodes are all 10 minutes too long. By the time it was like it was like, okay, dude, I can only see this fucking farmer staring at the goddamn sky so many times, you know? It
sounds like the plot was a little bit ambling.
When it, really was, it really was.
Rambling. Like,
That's what should be the name of our media company. It's just Rambling. It has to have been done. Rambling Entertainment. It was still a dope show.
I really liked the Japanese episode because they kind of tied it all together and like, and they were like, oh yeah, we bombed Japan. And then aliens started showing up.
Or was
it the nuclear reactor?
It was all that. All that
combined. It was both of them.
Yeah. Well, hilariously, the reboot of Unsolved Mysteries on Netflix also did the fucking the lights in Japan, the same shit. The fucking, it was like kind of from a different angle.
Was it over like Fukushima?
The Fukushima and the lights of like spirits and yada yada and whatever. It's kind of similar.
Something that was like, that was all the Grand Haven shit.
Yeah, that was Unsolved Mysteries.
Did we talk about that?
No, I don't think we have, but yeah, that was a big one.
Because I swear you said you had a fucking UFO experience or something like that.
Well, I didn't. I didn't give it away too much, but my homie Bubba, our homie Bubba, who fucking, we're doing a UFO thing that's involved in that right now that we just did the pilot episode for and whatever, and he claims that he saw that shit back in the day, that like during that time or whatever. But I mean, it's one of those things where like, it comes back out and then everybody's like, yeah, I saw it, you know what I mean, or whatever. But I mean, it was like a big fucking deal back in, it was like 94 that shit went down or something.
I was watching the Encounters is what it's called, right? And they said one thing and I was like, oh, that fucking makes sense, like aliens are totally fucking here. And it's the water and the fact that water on any planet, and there's planets all across the fucking universe that have water in them or on them. As long as that water's not frozen or boiling, water's the same everywhere.
Yeah.
And so aliens can fucking come to Earth and just go underwater.
Yeah.
As long as they have that, you know,
they just
that lifestyle sustained.
They just got to
Because between, you know, 32 degrees Fahrenheit and 100 or 200 degrees Fahrenheit, that shit's stable.
The Goldilocks
live
zone.
There.
Yeah. Is that your take on it? Do you think that shit's real with all the Tic Tacs and stuff that go underwater and all?
Well, hey man, that kind of makes sense, man.
Yo, you're getting too Tom DeLonge right now, bro.
And you know, the poles, you know, you can fucking go in
hollow
there.
Earth, bro.
The hollow Earth and hollow moon shit's hollow Earth fucking society. Wild, son.
Yeah. Hollow Earth's been around
the
since way back
then. The moon is Transformers. The Earth is Anunnaki.
Right.
Transformers.
Yeah,
is
there
that
was
part of the Transformers thing?
Transformers thing where they fucking, they were like, they colonized the moon or something like that.
The cartoon? I hear they're making fucking a Beast Wars movie.
They did.
That came out a year ago.
Dude, there's so much of this. I'm sorry. There's so much of this bullshit. I cannot keep up on this fucking garbage. Okay. Transformers stink. I'm sorry. They stink.
Step your Beast Wars fucking, game knowledge up, bro.
I didn't even hear that it came. I heard coming out. I didn't see a single goddamn preview for it. Beast Wars back in the day was the shit, though.
Yeah, it
fucking
was.
Fifth Optimus grade, Primal. Dude. Fucking coming home watching that shit. It was like early fucking computer animation.
Hell
shit.
Yeah.
It was dope as fuck, dude. Did you guys see the movie? And how bad did it suck?
I saw the movie. And
I'd give it a 2.5 out of 5.
Out of 10.
As far as Transformers movies go, the first one was dope because it was the first Transformers movie.
Yeah.
All the rest of them were fucking
Michael
balls.
Bay. Yeah.
First one was
fun. And this
fun,
one
dude.
Wasn't yeah. that bad.
Yeah.
Top three of the seven or whatever that they've made, probably.
Did they make that many?
They've made a lot.
All starting fucking... Megan Fox had that fucking
Megan
show.
Megan Fox had...
She was
one,
in two.
She was in two movies.
Yeah, no, but she was doing a show on the History Channel that was like a fucking Unsolved Mysteries.
Megan Fox is in the new Mortal Kombat game.
I'll allow that.
Yeah.
It's
pretty sweet. She's a vampire. She gets her head fucking cut off all the time.
In the new game or the...
In the game.
Oh, okay.
How is Mortal Natara these days are the chillest. Yeah, the new game's bad. I haven't played a fucking
There's no way.
Well, 15 minutes
making,
from here.
They've started
I will
making.
Go get my PS5 right now.
Let's
and kick
go.
It's probably
asses.
Worthwhile.
Mortal Kombat is now an RPG as well as a fighting game.
Really?
They've made some changes and it's pretty.
Last time I was
solid.
Playing Mortal Kombat, it was on Xbox. Inglot had his Xbox and it was like Annihilation and. There was like two of them back to back, like Devastation or Annihilation and something.
Deadly
like that.
Alliance probably and Annihilation.
I know one was like Annihilation, and then like they had kind of a sequel to that. That was kind of the same game or whatever. But fucking those games are so fucking sick, dude. And fucking I was always playing. Who's the fucking the Indian dude? Native American guy. Dude, with the tomahawks and shit, I was pretty dominant with that guy. I'm not gonna lie.
I was always a fan of the glitch characters. I had Noob Saibot and Smoke and Rain.
That's a good call.
All the glitch characters.
Why do they call them glitch?
Because they were actually a glitch in the original making of the game. So like Ermac was a glitch of Reptile. It was just literally a game glitch where he showed up as different colors.
So then they developed their own character.
Eventually they developed their own characters, but they started out as glitches of the original characters.
Up, down, left, right, left, right. No.
Start, select.
So for the RPG shit, is it a like trade off blows? Is it like old school RPG?
It's not turn based. It's more like. Like Souls, like where they have like you get like a tribute. Like each character has an element or whatever. Okay. That like Scorpion's fire, you know. Liu Kang is fire. Sub Zero is ice. Rain is water.
Sub Zero's ice.
But then you can add
no.
Then you can
spoiler alert, bro. Jeez, I didn't play this.
Then you can add like if you want your character to have higher defense, and you can add that skill point. But as you level up, then each person gets the same number.
Love
like,
that, dude. Love the fucking.
It's pretty
that actually
cool.
sounds pretty dope. Not gonna lie,
there was a I badass. Like that.
It turned
fucking
me off at first because it's fucking hard.
Well, I can see that.
First,
that's what
too.
I was hard. I can just see it being like it's not classic Mortal Kombat.
That's
so
what
like,
I was
yeah.
saying. It's yeah, I want yeah, my there, Mortal Kombat to be Mortal Kombat. Right, make a different game for.
It is a different game.
I hear that. I hear
that. There's a whole mode you can go into that's just regular
tournament,
fucking Mortal Kombat.
Tournament mode, yeah.
That's choice.
He didn't see me playing that because he was watching me play the
Your
RPG
soul
mode.
Is mine.
Fucking, this
Your
is what I caught today. Fucking, we were talking about a few pods ago. Fucking, you guys catch any of this shit they're doing where they like cross? I don't even know what you call it. Cross fucking pollinate video games where they're like reprogramming old video games with different video games. And today I saw they did Mortal Kombat in Mario. So it's fucking sweet. He's playing as fucking Sing Sung or whatever. So he's able to switch to different characters. And so he's going through and it's Mario, for SNES, so it's the
nice.
SNES
okay.
Mario.
My favorite Mario.
Me too, right? And he's fucking, so he's going in, but it's like fucking laying the fucking ice on the fucking Koopa guy and fucking blowing it up. Whatever, fucking switches to fucking Katana. Was it Katrina? What's his
Katana?
Princess? Yeah, and you know, with the fans.
Cortana.
Like, cuts the thing in half, you know, and fucking with the fans and shit, and then like does the fucking whoever fucking where he dives into the fucking guy and fucking bursts him apart from there. But it's like in the Mario world.
Are these actual games or is it people just like making screenshots?
It's hard to say. It's a little.
It's probably a walkthrough. Yeah.
A lot of them are real games.
Some of them it's like, okay, you're clearly just animating this too, but it's kind of a little both. Yeah, it's fucking dope.
I was playing. Actually playing on my computer, it was like a Pokemon version, but they made it fucking like Castlevania.
Right, that's what I'm saying.
And it was all like vampires and evil shit trying to kill you the whole time, but you could catch it with like a rope or something and then just like fucking play Pokemon with a Dracula.
That's
wild. So funny, dude. You just see fucking like, I mean, like we're big Contra fan, so I'm seeing a lot of like Contra fucking ones that are like same thing, like they put the Contra guys in Mario, so you're going through fucking just blasting the Goombas with fucking machine guns and shit. It's fucking
giant
awesome.
Fucking somersault
around fucking blasting guys, talking spreads on Goombas,
it's
just
so
laying
great.
Waste, baby.
Mortal Kombat 2 might be it's definitely, I think, of the top five video games of all time.
Then
Mortal
come
Kombat
play
2,
Mortal
dude.
Kombat 1,
go,
which is
dude.
What they've called it. Like, seriously.
The new one?
Yeah. The graphically,
really,
it's going to blow your fucking mind.
I'm sure.
Like, it's just too good.
I'm so out of the loop on new video games,
like,
dude. I was just
watching his kid play the new Spider-Man game this afternoon, and
I'm sure
just, I got so
dope,
sucked
dude.
Into the storyline of it.
Dude, those Spider-Man
the graphics
games?
Are so good.
I heard that game is like the game of the year or whatever.
It
like,
will.
Yeah,
I played it for 5 minutes, and I said, this is the game of the fucking year. Like, there's nothing else
I was playing
that
PS2 one, which was like the first open world Spider-Man where you're fucking swinging it. Dude, I spent countless man hours playing that game, just all nighters. It's fucking ridiculous.
It looks pretty fucking dope.
That game is tough. This game is just like the Spider-Man 2 dropped today is one of the best looking games I've ever seen in my entire life.
Yeah.
And like there's like kaiju battles that you end up getting into with like Sandman. And
what the fuck
like,
is a kaiju battle?
A kaiju is a like it's a Japanese word for like giant monster. Like a
speak American, sir.
like a Godzilla.
Okay.
Is a kaiju.
Okay, gotcha.
All the monsters from Godzilla's universe are kaiju.
Interesting. All right.
Yeah, and then you play as both Spider-Man. You play as Spider-Man, Peter Parker, and Miles Morales, and you can switch back and forth. And there's 50 different fucking suits for each of them.
They all look dope, and they brought them all the way back from like the 80s forward.
And it's basically the game you were talking about, where you can swing around in an open world, except it's the entirety of New York fucking city.
And it's 4K.
And
every like there's the real fucking buildings, and they really get blown up, and then you know the government gets blamed for it.
I hear it's a really good game.
It's dang.
No, I hear it's fantastic.
It's dang.
You know.
How is the jump from PS4 to PS5 ridiculous, dude? I have not allowed myself
having
to
borrowed
buy
his
one.
PS4 and looking at the PS5 stuff. It's insane.
It's tremendous. Yeah. I mean, do you remember the jump from PS2 to PS3?
Yeah,
it's double that. It's tremendous. I mean, it's
tremendous.
I'm fucking off the urge to get one, dude.
They're getting progressively more longer in their jumps.
Yeah.
I saw some shit today. I think it was on The Onion or The Hard Times, either one. It was like PS5 brings back that slot on the back where you could hide your weed. It was like where the power supply or something went. Where, like,
I remember that slot.
That's hilarious.
I remember that slot well.
It was the GameCube for me where the slot's a little bigger.
But, I was like, that's the greatest fucking thing I've ever seen. So dead on. Man, I'm so fucking out of loop on fucking video games. Susan's playing the new Zelda, so I'm fucking watching her playing that. I'm a big Zelda fan, but I haven't played the last couple. I just kind of gave up on video games. I just don't have time. I just kind of decided I don't have time. I'm like, I want to do music and shit. I just don't have time.
Yep.
Video games are dope, and I wish I had the time, and I'm not anti at all. But
I'm like a fucking heroin addict. Like, I can't allow myself to have it in the house. I had to stop buying Madden and Call of Duty and shit. Mm-hmm. And it's like, I'm spending a disproportionate amount of time getting wildly dominant.
Just a totally token white guy.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Yep. The whitest of games. NBA 2K. Making myself as a 6'8" black power forward. Just dominating some shows. Just reverse jamming on bitches, dude. Looking like a young Sean Kemp out there.
Why haven't they installed the dunk contest yet?
Yeah,
I need to use my gymnastic skills from when I was 7.
I need to make my actual self as like an NBA 2K guy, just like a 5'11 guy. He's really good from the 3-point line. He's a dominant free throw shooter. Outside of that, not so much. Basically just the basketball character. You know?
I make myself in FIFA. And I'm like 5'2" and just maximum speed.
Running around like a young Messi out there.
Just 100 speed, and that's all that I can't handle the ball or do anything like that. Just zooming around the field.
Superior straight line speed, baby.
Just 100 pounds.
Shit, man, that might have meant not be too inaccurate from reality, dude.
I've gained weight.
Have you?
Yeah, a little bit.
You look good, man.
Thanks.
I like your t-shirt, too. Yeah. What you got fucking going on there, dude?
FOB, my guy.
FOB?
Fallout Boy. Yeah, this is Dead Jayk on my shirt.
Dead Jayk?
Yeah, doesn't it look like him a little bit?
Is that a thing? I don't know.
You don't think so? It's got the fucking pompadour.
Yeah, I don't know, man. The shirt
kind of looks like you.
The shirt's a lot more handsome than fucking Jayk. Let's be honest.
It's a fucking skeleton.
Yeah.
I am less handsome than a skeleton.
There was a segue at one point where you started talking about the show that's happening tomorrow, but we didn't actually say what the show was.
What's the show?
It's at Gunlight Casino, and it's a tribute to emo and pop punk music.
Nice.
It's just four dudes from Chicago playing. The playlist is insane.
Yeah, it's our childhood. Like, our formative years, the age 14 to 18, every song we listened to for 4 years fucking straight.
And you guys are open for
them? Oh, no, God, no.
We're playing a show tomorrow, but we're going out to that afterwards.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
It blew my mind that somebody was actually doing it.
You can't go. You won't even hear about this until after it's over. So, sorry, guys.
That's right. Well, they're doing that shit all fucking over the place. There's all kinds of... I mean, that big music festival with the fucking...
Oh, I want to go to that side.
Yeah. What the fuck is that thing called?
When we were young.
When we were young, yeah.
Which is an Adele song.
But I would not spend the money.
Big Adele fan.
That place wants.
When we were young.
Everybody,
dude. Yeah.
Yeah. Talking about fucking. It's mostly Fall Out Boy.
I'll show you a list somewhere I'm brave.
If you go on Spotify, Jimmy World, and you look up like what is it like on Spotify? There's like an artist radio. Everybody that pops up on Fall Out Boy Radio or Panic at the Disco about Radio. This.
Is it multiple genres too? Like it's not just the pop
it's
punk.
Mostly,
thing. Is it,
mostly yeah. pop punk. Okay. Pop
it's
punk
like Vans Warped Tour.
It's, yeah.
But like bigger.
But we're all old.
But
now.
On, you know,
basically, it's literally
a
what
cutter's
it is.
Budget, if you will.
Speaking of bands of that era, I think the dude from Sum 41 just kicked the bucket. Does that
sound
right?
Yeah, really?
Sum 41 guy?
He was supposed to be there.
With the hair, yeah.
I thought, I don't know.
He was supposed to be there.
Yeah, 41 was on that list, so you know. So
My anymore. Chemical Romance.
Cut that one out.
Come back for that.
I thought he was coming on the pod. The Sum 41 guy, wasn't he fucking Avril Lavigne or whatever?
Yeah,
the lead singer.
Back in the day.
I might be wrong.
I gotta look that
sound
up.
One
the
of
guitarist
those...
Brown Sound. Some
that
Brown
was the,
Sound.
That was the,
you know what I'm talking
some
about.
Some kind
dude.
Of Fall Out Boy, Sum 41, yeah, something in that yeah, vein. Yeah. One of those dudes.
There's a fucking story in my fucking world of fucking my brother's bands and Rick Beam and all that shit. They were all fucking like set up to fucking get their shit to fucking this manager dude in Chicago. They fucking recorded shit. They had a hookup through the intersection, blah, 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 right? And fucking like they duffed it and never fucking got their shit to this guy. And fucking like a couple months later, he's managing some band called Fall Out Boy out of Chicago or whatever, and fucking the rest is fucking history, and they're fucking broke, and Fall Out Boy's swimming in pussy. So, I mean,
don't sleep on that shit.
Yep, exactly. So, there's more to that whole story, but I won't name names, but yeah, everybody fucked it up.
Everybody fucks it up.
I could be on the tour bus being the younger brother of the bassist in some band. Well, fucking bringing it back though, I was going to talk about fucking Tom DeLong, you know, fucking the UFO fucking king here, dude. Fucking just quitting one of the biggest bands in the world.
Well, now he's back.
I know, but like, and then bringing back, like, literally making some of the most fucking bounds in the UFO community that's been of the last 15 years. And then just being like, now I'm going to go
with DeLong.
DeLong be my band again.
It's called Monsters of California.
DeLong's thrown
it.
Is it like
down,
a
dude.
Fiction
it's a fucking alien
so
movie?
Whoa, dude.
Inappropriate.
So inappropriate, dude.
DeLong's like, I got better things to do. I've got unidentified flying objects to identify. So I can't be bothered.
There are objects flying about unidentified that I must
seriously.
Find the
I'm to be the
seriously.
One to say it. Tom DeLong stinks.
No way, rules.
That guy reeks of bullshit unlike any human being I've ever heard in my life, dude. It's like, oh, there's something big coming. There's something. I can't talk about the big thing that's coming, but it's, it stinks long. Fucking get out of here. Oh,
yeah,
man.
You ever hear fucking
rat bastard?
Whatever, Travis
as
Barker,
as
you're attacking
record.
My childhood.
Bro,
you know?
I'm
bro.
Coming for DeLong, baby.
Listen,
got a hardline stance.
As long
on
as he makes a decent album, I don't give a shit.
Well, fucking
shit about
Travis Barker was talking about like touring with him, like in the day. You know, obviously they did a lot of tours, and he's like, yeah, we just like smoke weed, and Tom DeLong would just be like going off about Bigfoot for like 12 hours on the bus.
It's pretty awesome.
It is awesome, dude. That's me, dude. I love that shit. It's so funny.
If only podcasts that existed back then.
Seriously. Oh, God, it's so terrible.
It would just be called, Hey, Mom, there's something in the background.
Yeah. I'm fucking dying here. All right, boys, let's take a break on that, and I'm going to pee my pants. I got more fucking notes on Tom DeLong, though, too.
War in the Middle East.
The March of War. Sponsored by Snacky Smalls. Yes, man. That's the whole fucking, that's the whole thing that I'm doing on the little clip that we're playing here is me doing Trey Parker doing Trey Parker doing shitty newscasts from the 1940s, you know?
Some real meta shit. Dude.
Sponsored by Snacky Smalls.
Oh, other words.
All right. So, you know, my friend...
What's happening?
Not a whole lot. It's been a fucking busy week, dude. From what I understand, there's a whole lot cooking out there in this fine big world of ours.
I love this part of the podcast.
Been busy at work, man. It's hard to keep up with what's fucking happening.
If only there were a way, some kind of mechanism to help inform and educate the masses, my friend.
Seems like there should be. You know, I might just fucking, have an answer to that.
You want the honors this week?
No, it's all you. Go ahead.
Let's get right into it.
Dangerville Podcast presents News of the World.
Sponsored by Snacky Smalls. Apparently, I'm on my own this week. It's been a few weeks since I've fucking had any news, and
I'm looking up some news.
I'm forewarning you, gentlemen. It is, it's not good. Well, it's not good.
You know, my friend, the bar has been set pretty high by yours truly. Indeed. When you're competing with a comic mind such as my own, it's an imposing task, to be sure, to say the least.
I know, man. I love your news bits. They're so great.
It's dang.
No, man. Everything you do is just...
It's dang.
All right, we're getting fucking into it here. Jesus Christ, pray for me, boys.
Yep.
All right. Furious podcasters claim that Cast Media's Colin Thompson owes them millions. Mm. You guys following this story at all?
I don't know what any of that means.
Okay, soak it in a little bit. I'll explain it to you. Big name celebrities are rounding on the man. Some call the Bernie Madoff of podcasting.
Wow.
An executive they claim has potentially defrauded them of millions of dollars.
Whoa, okay.
I know. At least three major podcasters are accusing Colin Thompson, the CEO of Cast Media, of charging advertisers for commercials they read on air, but failing to pay the podcast hosts for their share of the commission.
Damn.
Yep. Two podcasters claim they have stopped receiving any income owed since the fall of last year.
Wow.
Yep. One of the alleged victims is Theo Von, a comedian and YouTube star with 2 million subscribers. Everybody knows Theo, right?
Wow. Yeah.
Yeah. Recently, Von made a viral podcast titled "This Man Defrauded Our Podcast," which has been viewed by 1.6 million people, in which Von rages about Thompson's alleged duplicity.
Damn, dude.
Yeah, for
real. Taking a long time to get to the joke here. This is
seriously,
big setup, big swing here.
Yeah, well, listeners of the Dangerville podcast can rest easy knowing we have made no money of any kind and continue to hope to be defrauded in the future.
Indeed. That's really kind of the goal when you get right down to is to get big enough to be defrauded by this douchebag for sure.
Can we have a segment later where we just have Theo Vonisms?
Yes.
Have you seen these?
No, like, but man, I love that guy, dude.
I had a uncle back in the day. He used to fucking fuck chickens behind the barn. I walked behind there one time. There was 4 chickens lined up just waiting for their eggs to get fertilized. Son of a bitch. I'm Theo Vaughn.
That's a pretty solid Theo Vaughn.
Just some shit,
my favorite one that he ever fucking set off the cuff on fucking Rogan was he goes, it was when everybody was being Me Too'd and shit, right? And he goes, man, I feel like I got to go over to Riverside just to jerk off. He's like, I got to get out of town even to just fucking rub one out.
There was a lady. I was on the train the other day, and this lady, she woke me up. She said, your manhood is showing. And she said, don't make me call the stewardess. And I was like, bitch, I was asleep. I can't. Since when can I not get an erection while I'm sleeping?
I heard one the other day. It was part of one of his specials I caught, and he's like, "Yeah, I got into a fight with a black guy the other day. I don't know if you ever fought a black guy, but they win." Yeah, it's a banger, dude.
Yeah, man, that motherfucker says shit that just like is just nobody else fucking knows. All right, moving right along here, boys. We're still doing the news. Ring doorbells. Mm-hmm. Ring doorbells. Offering a $1 million reward for alien activity captured on your doorbell.
I heard about
that. Did you guys see this?
Brilliant plan.
Yeah.
There,
man. Mm-hmm.
About to fake the shit out of a
abduction. Well, submissions for the Out of This World competition will be judged on creativity, humor, and engagement with a Ring device.
Mm-hmm.
Security company Ring is offering $1 million to a lucky Earthling who captures extraterrestrial activity on their video doorbell or camera. Whether it's an alien coming up the driveway or floating in your backyard, Ring encourages you to submit, blah, blah, blah. Let's see here. In news that may or may not be related. It may or may not be related, boys.
Can neither confirm nor deny. Yep.
Jaime Musan, a Mexican journalist and the man behind the recent alien bodies that were shown before Mexican Congress, has recently been spotted at his local arts and crafts store.
Okay.
Wait. I am receiving an update, a real-time update.
Oh, wow.
I'm receiving an update.
This is a Dangerville first.
Yes, real-time. Yep. The crack team of reporters here at Dangerville has confirmed that Ice Cube, Snoop Dogg, Too Short, and D40, collectively known as Mount Westmore, have, in fact, caught it on the Ring.
Mm-hmm. All right.
All right. Let's go.
If you don't know the Mount Westmore record, that will not make sense.
Can you press that button again?
Let's go, Jerry. Go!
Oh, you were actually laughing.
That was me actually laughing.
I was 100% sure you
In fairness, nobody's ever heard an actual laugh during the news segment here.
Nobody's laughing here. Let's be real.
How far does this alien caught on the Ring thing go? Like, if I catch my neighbor Juan on there, am I pulling down this million bucks? Or what's the stipulation?
It burns from the thing. We bring you love. Do you remember that shit?
That Halloween episode.
We bring you peace. He's all radioactive.
Nuclear birds.
All right, guys, we're a serious news program here. Let's move it along a little bit. What do we got here? The former Florida lawmaker who sponsored the Don't Say Gay bill has been sentenced to prison for COVID-19 relief fraud.
Well, oh, this is great. Santos, right?
No, some guy in that.
Santos got the same thing.
Oh, man, I don't know. We'll see what this guy's
Santos here.
The former Florida lawmaker who sponsored the controversial Don't Say Gay bill was sentenced to 6 months in federal prison Thursday for defrauding a federal coronavirus relief loan program for small businesses.
Well played.
Jesus Christ.
I think I accidentally did this. I'm being totally honest.
It was you.
No, not this specific instance, but... So, during the whole, like, coronavirus thing, if you were part-time, but, like, if they cut you from full-time down to part-time,
yeah,
you could collect unemployment for that,
right,
for
yeah.
the difference.
Right, yeah.
And I was working full-time hours at one point.
But
I was never full-time.
Yeah, there was a lot of that shenanigans going on.
And so,
yeah.
I started collecting unemployment to make up for the second half of that. And I think I'm going to go to jail.
Well, be careful because there's a lot of federal agencies that constantly monitor this program specifically. So just be careful, boys. Mm-hmm. Be careful. So this was former state representative Joe Harding, a 36-year-old Republican, resigned in December after being charged with fraudulently obtaining more than $150,000 from the Small Business Administration in pandemic aid loans. He pleaded guilty in March to wire fraud, money laundering, and making false statements in connection with COVID-19.
Ooh, that's a toughie.
I know. U.S. Attorney General, or whatever the fuck, Jason Cody said, in a news release, hey, it doesn't matter because of where you're going. It doesn't matter if you're gay or not. Just don't drop the soap. That's it.
Worst episode.
That was the joke. It maybe would have landed if I could have got it all out in one.
Sorry.
In one piece.
I am being completely interruptive today. Like, this is.
It's fine. It's terrible, terrible material. Moving right along here in the next news segment. Another Florida man, sticking with the Florida man is sentenced to 1 year in federal prison for trying to run over six black men.
Jesus Christ.
Yeah. A 62-year-old white man was convicted of attempting to run down six black men at the site of a Rosewood massacre, which has been sentenced. This fucking makes no sense here.
Yeah.
They were at the site of the Rosewood massacre. Okay.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. So yeah. David Allen Emanuel, the fucking defendant, appeared solemn and reserved on Thursday as federal judge Alan Windsor delivered the sentence on 6 counts of hate crimes for attempting to run over historian Marvin Dunn, his son, and 4 other black men who were surveying Dunn's Rosewood property to build a memorial for the massacre.
Jesus Christ.
I know. It's a lot. It's a lot.
That's, yeah.
Yeah, they were very solemn. It was a very solemn event.
Yeah, that would seem to be a hat-in-hand moment if ever there were one.
Yeah, for real. And, you know, so that's what Emanuel did make a statement to the press while being led out of the courtroom, saying he wasn't trying to run anyone over, but it was dark and none of them were smiling.
Jesus Christ.
It was a very solemn moment.
Man, we're gay.
Yeah, they were being...
Thank you. It's been a great run.
You know what? Andrew Schultz made the same goddamn joke on his special that got millions of views, so fuck it up.
Yeah, that's a classic.
Oh, is that the... I know what you're talking about.
He made some other joke about rolling with it. I mean, that's a classic.
Yeah, he did the blackface one, right? The Marines commercial?
Yeah, it's a classic joke.
I don't remember that one.
You don't remember that one?
No.
He was like, blackface, wrong, right? Blackface, can't do it.
Yeah.
Racist.
Yeah.
And then he was like, you ever seen those Marines commercials?
Oh, where they're in blackface?
You know, you got a white dude next to you and you're trying to snipe somebody. Blackface.
Right, yeah.
You heard about Schultz first, boys.
Yeah, can't cancel Schultz. Me.
All right, moving right along here.
Not stealing jokes, just Schultzing.
Health providers say that AI chatbots could improve care, but research says some are perpetuating racism.
Oh, wow.
Mm-hmm. As hospitals and healthcare systems turn to artificial intelligence to help summarize doctors' notes and analyze health records, a new study led by Stanford School of Medicine researchers cautions that popular chatbots are perpetuating racist, debunk medical ideas.
No good. No good for business.
It's crazy. This has prompted concerns that the tools could worsen health disparities after several black patients visited their primary care providers and were prescribed watermelon and fried chicken.
Jesus Christ.
The makers of HitlerBot responded, saying they could find no deficiencies in their algorithm.
Like coming hard with the black jokes today.
It was just what was in the news, boys.
Pretty good.
All right, so that's all I got on the jokes. But then the last news fucking thing is this is a real story here. Is fucking fourth graders are distraught after Winnie the Pooh, Blood and Honey, the horror movie, somehow gets shown in classrooms. So according to a parent who spoke with CBS Miami, their child and classmates were, quote, exposed to approximately a half hour of the Winnie the Pooh parody horror film that dropped this year that reimagines the beloved children's character as a serial killer who dons a poo mask while stalking his prey.
That's incredible, so dude. That's so
how
good.
Really?
So
fourth graders,
yes.
Dude. Yes. I would have been like, this rules.
I love the accidentally showing right, for a half an hour. Like
some drunk ass
degenerate
ass, fucking
some Bob Lynch-er fucking
in the room.
School teacher.
I was going, yeah,
all right, kids.
The new Winnie the Pooh is great, I heard. He's like, all hungover as fuck. I was going, yeah, I heard it's good. Well, whatever. We're all going to sit quiet in the dark right now.
So is this an animated thing?
No.
Is it like
no.
CGI?
Yeah, dude.
Really?
It's like Friday the 13th in a fucking Winnie
that's
the Pooh
amazing,
mask.
Dude.
Oh, dude, you haven't
Blood
seen that
Blood and
shit?
Honey
it's
is a hilarious
so
fucking name,
apparently,
too.
They're already making 2 sequels. I can't believe you haven't caught Blood and Honey.
No,
I haven't seen it either.
I will like, be immediately.
Yeah, we should fucking watch that shit, dude.
There is a potential spoiler alert for the Halloween special right
not,
there. We should
be
watching
Blood
some
and Honey, but it
blood
should,
and
be.
Honey,
it should be Blood and Honey.
That's a miss on your part, my friend.
The Halloween podcast.
You know, I'd love to tell you, but that's a big fucking
is it
surprise.
A fucking secret?
Yeah, next week or when is that? Next week or 2 weeks?
This douchebag is withholding
then,
the
then
information
you can release it for
me.
Halloween.
Mm-hmm.
Do it on Friday, whatever you're doing.
Nobody can know what the
show up. It's fine.
Come out, dude.
You gotta have it.
Yeah, it's
the more the merrier situation.
What's the is it 27th?
27th, yeah.
We'll go shows.
Bitch. Oh yeah, we'll be in fucking
Grand
Haven.
That's fucking lame.
I'll be here at like 2 a.m.
Come out, fools.
Yeah, we'll show up afterwards. We'll get drunk with you guys at about 2 a.m.
Yeah.
We'll just get passed out on your lawn after the show.
I mean, that's what we're doing, dude.
Been there a time or two.
I thought it was a secret.
Where are you guys playing out in Grand Haven?
Kirby House.
Kirby's show. Kirby's a fun spot. Yeah.
Good food.
So I've got a couple stories for you gentlemen.
Oh, you have stories too?
This one I know you saw because you sent it to me, ironically, the day that I saw it. But the Tupac murder, baby.
Yeah.
We got movement in the Tupac murder.
Yeah, we
did you
do.
See
yeah.
this? Yeah. They finally made an arrest. I actually saw this a little bit before you, you know, being kind of the crack mm-hmm. newsman that
oh,
I am,
sure.
my friend. So
and
saw
no
it a little bit before.
I'm sure.
But they hadn't made an arrest at that time, but they got this dude, Dwayne Kef D. Davis.
Yeah, Jada Pinket.
Who apparently is like the... oh, she's been going off,
dude,
by the way,
going,
dude. Really
yeah,
making
dude,
tours about...
It's hard,
dude.
It's
oh,
hard
yeah,
right
dude.
Now, bro.
Tell us about who killed Tupac, and then tell us about why they killed Tupac.
Okay, so this Kef D. dude, I guess they got his fucking search warrant for his house. He was like self-proclaimed. No, God damn it. Let's just talk Jada. Let's
go.
Get out of this motherfucker.
Will Smith. Dude, you gotta have it. I'm sorry. Go.
If Will Smith killed Tupac, dude, what an incredible turn of events that would be.
Oh, that's the fucking
he makes it big without swearing, but he
just backhanded him to death, dude. Just fucking beat him into submission. But no, it's just the uncle of this dude. Apparently, he's like this self-proclaimed fucking gangster of the streets.
Yep.
He's like this top shot guy.
Yep.
Fucking running roughshod over these gangs and putting weed in motion and this
mm-hmm,
kind of shit.
Mm-hmm.
So like everybody's dead from the Tupac era, which is fucked up because it's not that long ago. Like they're all dead, all in that OG gangster life. So this uncle, this top shot caller, fucking uncle remains.
How much Tupac in you got?
This guy's got like a memoir where he's basically talking about all this shit. They ripped all these computer files, all this shit from him, fucking arrested him way after the fact.
Yep.
I guess there's not much more to say. We'll see what happens. They arrested a guy for Tupac's murder.
Yeah, he was
apparently
like
was not the trigger puller,
exactly,
but it sounds like I think he kind of fucking orchestrated
this. I was in the car or something like that. I was in the car. Somebody in the car.
Dude, there is
may or
so
may not
much
have been
fucking
me
Jada memes
Tupac
and shit going on right now. It is off the fucking charts. I don't even know what's going on, dude.
She's
but
really having a hate. Well, she like dated Tupac back in the day.
Yeah,
so
way
of
back
course
in the day.
She's fucking.
I saw a thing that said that she said that told Will Smith that all of his movies sucked, and that one time while
I saw
they were
that
fucking, she made him put on the movie that Tupac was in.
That's a real power move on her part. Ooh. Wow, that's a big swing, Jake.
Would it be inappropriate to masturbate to that right now?
I'm a little chubby talking about it.
To
like,
Jada watching Tupac?
Yes.
No.
I'm slightly bricked up by this situation.
I don't know why we're watching audio files happen there. This could be interesting.
Okay, well, we've all given each other a fucking nice HJ here. So
yeah,
that's fucking
buddy.
God, fucking Pro Tools is such fucking bullshit. I can't fucking get a DAW that works better or works worse at the same time.
Studio One.
I've tried it, man.
Pro Tools. That's what we're calling the box that Ross pulled out from under the chair.
I've had no issues other than with my computer's performance.
Full of tools.
What the fuck were we talking about? Jesus Christ.
Jerking off to Jada Pinkett.
Well, I mean, that'll happen. Dude, there, nothing gets me going like her fucking bald ass head, dude, you know?
I was just thinking that about you.
What I want to do is rub my bald head on her bald head, you know?
Yeah, totally.
Oh, yeah. Scary to get the friction there and the fucking, the Velcro of the fucking,
the stubble.
I gotta tell you, dude.
Wait, who's hooking who's loop for that?
It's like, what do they call a fucking catcher and, you know, whatever. Yeah,
pitcher,
I'm
the catcher.
I'm the hook. You hook or loop. That's hilarious, dude. Sorry, go ahead. What?
I don't remember where I was going. I will say Jada Pinkett Smith in The Nutty Professor, dude, is about as smoking hot of a woman as you've ever seen. Can we pull up some Jada Pinkett Nutty Professor material real quick?
The Nutty Professor.
That seems like a porno waiting to happen.
Yes.
But Jada Pinkett's fucking out of control. I never heard that shit with turning down the Tupac movie and she was fucking Will,
Holy
dude.
Shit, that was her.
And by the way, as a straight man, dude, Will Smith's a pretty goddamn looking guy.
Right.
So, like, her fucking breaking his balls like that and really dominating him that much is kind of hot in and of itself.
She's the biggest star in the world.
She's just a piece
she
of shit.
She sucks, dude. She's getting memed out of the fucking existence right now. It is hilarious.
But soak in some Jada Pinkett during Nutty Professor.
All right, dude.
That's pretty good.
It's fine,
bro.
Dude.
That's pretty good, son.
It's all right. Whatever.
G.I. Jada.
I'm at a full three-quarters inches right now.
Which is what they call her because she's literally raping Will Smith right now.
Yeah.
I got to say, I can't do chicks with short hair regardless of who it is, man. See, you take the hottest chick in the world, chop the hair short.
Stop it.
Can't do it. I
like
it.
You can do it.
Stop it.
Yeah.
Natalie Portman when she chopped it down short.
It's fucking what's her name.
Sorry.
Help. Help.
Sinead O'Connor.
In what? Yeah.
Sinead,
I'm
baby.
Snapping. Hold on.
In what? From where?
The new Black Widow.
Oh, what's her name?
Yes. Yeah. Yes.
Yes.
The chick who plays in fucking the new Batman who plays...
Florence Pugh, the one we've made a tweet about.
Oh, yeah, why is that
I
name
tweeted
so
at her.
Familiar.
I don't do that.
Jake versus dude tweeting at people, dude. You're
and we got zero followers.
Oh yeah, our Jake versus Jake has a Twitter, and we have no followers.
All
and we
do.
Just tweet like I tweeted Post Malone when we released that song,
and
he
I
tweeted mean, Florence Pugh saying that he'd think of her at night.
All Jesus I ever do Christ, is tweet dude. When I'm drunk. Like it's the only time
you're
it's allowed.
The drunk tweeter.
It's not even
that's exactly what it is.
What, is it
it's not even
form.
Tweeting anymore.
It's,
you're Xing, dude. What do you even call it anymore?
I don't know.
You can't even say.
X's, hugs, or kisses?
You're X-ing.
Kisses.
All right, well, I'm kissing at him now.
Are they?
Yeah.
What is this is chick it? From? Oh, okay. She looks vaguely familiar.
Vaguely? Vaguely? Voogly.
Who?
Florence Pugh?
I've heard
from,
the name. I don't
she was
know
in the new,
she, is,
she was in the new Black Widow movie. She was in Midsommar.
Okay.
Oh, that's
Midsommar?
Been on the watch list for a fucking long time.
Is she the star of that?
Yeah, she's the star of that.
Was it Shoeless? Right. I've heard very,
Midsommar
very good things.
Is,
I called the first like 20
weird.
Minutes and I fucking loved
it's
it.
Fucking
it
was, yeah.
It's
fucking weird.
It's the same director that did that Hereditary flick,
yeah,
right? I want to say
so, yeah.
That I did see Hereditary.
It's something we'd have been watching with
banger,
Skoke
so.
In the fucking
yeah,
baby.
Dude.
Shout out Skoke, dude. The fucking epic fucking horror movie.
That was a run, dude. Going through the top 10. So
yeah.
Obviously there are like 1,000 lists,
about-
but we found one that's the top 10, you know, most fucked up horror movies
yeah.
of all time. Went in reverse order, dude. Jesus
yeah,
Christ.
Yeah, that Midsommar
dude.
Movie. The only thing about it is it seems like it could
no
really
spoilers,
fucking happen.
No spoilers. I'm definitely
happen.
Watching it, yeah.
Like, that's the
yeah,
one thing
yeah,
about it. Like,
yeah.
I've seen horror movies where it's like, oh yeah, that fucking, that guy, he just popped up out of the fucking lake and he murdered everybody.
Yeah.
Or whatever, you know. Oh, they tricked him. This shit seemed like that cult seems real.
Yeah.
The thing about that movie is that it's very difficult to jerk off to. So, you know, I got it done. I'm
actually,
just saying.
There are
know,
a couple sex
was,
scenes in that movie.
I don't. I only saw the first like 20 minutes and it was super fucked up. But I need to catch the whole.
It gets,
fucking thing.
It gets
yeah.
weirder.
Yeah, indeed.
Yeah.
Oh, I'm sure.
I
oh,
did
I'm
just watch
it.
That. That No One Will Save You. Which shout out Jordan. Was talking about
oh,
that
yeah.
shit a little bit.
Indeed.
So it was pretty chill. It's a pretty badass movie.
Right.
Like an alien flick, like a pseudoscience type
oh,
situation.
Shit.
Have you motherfuckers seen fucking, am I the only one who's watched Fall House of Usher so
oh,
far?
I watched it twice.
Dude, it's fucking fantastic, dude.
It's fucking, it came out, listen, it came
spoiler
out a week
alert.
Ago. I watched it
yeah.
twice.
Spoiler alert.
I'm not allowed.
He hasn't seen it.
Okay, yeah, stay,
earmuffs.
Keep your headphones off.
I mean, have you not seen it, Jake?
Is Susan into Poe?
Oh yeah, we watched it together. Yeah, yeah.
I just like I've seen some of her artwork and kind of you know.
Yeah, honestly, neither one of us. Well, okay, let's talk about this because we can't talk about spoilers on that because these two fucking assholes haven't seen the fucking greatest show of the season. is fucking honestly, like I've read a like I'm a huge H.P. Lovecraft fan. You know Stephen King later horror stuff whatever. Poe is difficult for me.
Is
and like I've read, you know, it's not even the language. Like, you know, you can go earlier into Shakespeare and whatever. Like, I don't know. I've tried. Like, I've tried a bunch of times. Like, the fucking thing's right fucking here somewhere. And fucking, I've tried reading it. I got the audiobooks. Like, I've tried getting in on actual fucking Poe stuff.
This was the best translation of Poe that I've ever seen.
Well, because he completely basically disregards a lot of it and makes it a modern story.
He modernized it.
You know, like, yeah. And so it's like, yeah,
I've seen everything that it's Mike Flanagan is the producer of those. Yeah. I've seen everything he's done. Flanagan. The Midnight Club, Midnight Mass.
Dude, Flanagan
is the best. He's the best.
Yeah.
The way I got exposed to him, the first flick that I saw from Flanagan was this movie with his wife. She's in a bunch of his shit, obviously.
She's in everything.
But she's like a deaf chick. In a house by herself out in the woods.
That's the only one I haven't seen.
And is getting stalked by this killer, but she can't hear anything. And there's like next to no dialogue in this flick. Him. It's a fucking badass movie, dude.
I got
to
see that.
Talking off my ass. Maybe it's not even
Midnight
funny.
Midnight Mass is the best.
Midnight Mass is fucking good.
Unbelievable.
But I thought this was his
Fall
best.
Of the House of Usher might be the best thing he's ever done because it's also kind of hilarious. It's a little more tongue-in-cheek, you know, like Midnight Mass and the fucking House of Bly or whatever they're in fucking Bly Manor or whatever.
Haunted Hill.
Yeah, and Haunted Hill is like hits emotionally. Like it's deep. Like you fucking cry watching that shit. Where like Fall of the House of Usher has some moments, but like it's also like a little more like just kind of straight up funny in some ways or something, like, and it's not super long.
Hush,
you know.
Hush,
there you
yes.
go. There you go.
Hush is sure. Is it Flanagan? I hope.
Yeah.
Okay.
He also directed. He's directed several Stephen King adaptations, including Gerald's Game.
Gerald's Game is sure.
There was Gerald's
starring,
Game was referenced.
Yes, you caught it.
I caught that.
Because it's also starring the guy who plays Roderick Usher from Gerald's Game.
And the
Game.
Chick, too.
Sam, might be. Carla Gugino. I don't know how you say her name. She's a top 10 for me.
I know. You're super
Carla Gugino in
her
prime.
She's one
my
of the stars
Jesus
of
Christ,
Fall of the House of Usher.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, she's fucking great. And his wife, that chick who is fucking a great actress, and there's a lot of great fucking performances put down and fucking
watch it.
I can't believe you guys have not seen this shit.
I gotta get on it.
Jesus Christ.
Twice.
Dude, so
I don't watch shit anymore.
Dude,
I stare at a computer screen all day.
We were watching it, dude, and fucking when we finished it, in my living room, I literally applauded. I was like, yes, thank you. This is the coolest fucking. This is so
Flanagan
cool. So
fucking rules.
He really does, dude. He fucking owns.
Yeah.
He's trying to adapt fucking the Dark Tower from Stephen King, which is a big deal.
That's
big
difficult.
Deal. Yeah. Well, obviously they tried it once, starring fucking and
it's
it was
not
just
a movie.
A shit show. He's trying
to
do
it. Can't make it a movie. You'd have to do it.
So
series.
Long. You can't do one movie or whatever.
Isn't there a Dark Tower thing with Idris Elba?
Yeah, it was
Idris Elba.
Yeah,
okay.
Was that
McConaughey.
The Stephen King
awful.
Thing?
Yeah, same. Okay. Yeah. Oh yeah,
I've
considered
not seen it,
one of the worst adaptations of all time.
That sounds about right.
Starring Idris Elba.
Oh man,
in fairness,
not as bad as Storm of the Century.
I didn't even see that fucking piece of shit.
There have been a ton of dog shit Stephen King adaptations.
It's not easy to adapt Stephen King, and I feel like for as fucking awesome as he is, right? As fucking, he's just kind of like, whoever's paying me, he's just like, pay me.
Yeah.
He's just been like, whatever, go ahead, you know? Like,
which is
like
the way to do it.
Shitty ass. One of the worst movies ever made. Did you guys ever see Dreamcatcher, the movie?
Yeah. Yes.
Dude. I consider Dreamcatcher, the movie, to be one of the worst films ever made.
Dreamcatcher is very terrible.
It is extremely awful in every conceivable way. And the reason that I fucking caught it, I don't know if I've told this on the pod or not, but is because they were showing the first movie from the Animatrix before the movie.
Jada Pinkett. It all comes back around.
Baby.
So they were showing, fucking Final Flight of the Osiris?
Yep.
You know, obviously you do, because we watch it literally 1,000 times in Kalamazoo.
I have a 3-week-old son whose name is Osiris.
Nice. That's badass.
That's a prime
congrats.
Name.
Shout out Osiris.
Hey, Osiris. That's a great name. Well played. Final Flight of the Osiris. Fucking The Matrix. So fucking we literally go to the fucking theater to watch this fucking Animatrix 10-minute, thing like that they're like showing like special edition before fucking this Stephen King-y horror movie, which okay, we're like, yeah, that sounds cool enough, whatever. I'm sure the movie's fine or whatever. So we go there, watch the fucking thing. It shows fucking the Matrix thing. It's fucking dope. And then we watch this fucking movie and I literally could, I should have left. I can't believe how bad it is, but I don't know. That's I got
two submissions.
Really made me want to go snowmobiling. How many meals have you actually got up and walked out of?
Ooh, that's a great question. I've only ever walked out of one movie.
I remember you telling me, but I don't remember what it is.
You remember what it is? What it was? It was Club Dread.
The
follow-up to Super Troopers, one of my favorite movies fucking ever. Fucking Broken Lizard, the comedy guys or whatever. Which now I think Club Dread's hilarious. But like after Super Troopers...
No, your first instinct was more than crazy. It's an indescribably terrible movie.
I think it's pretty funny.
The only
redeeming
part of that movie is Bill Paxton, to be clear.
There's some funny shit in it, but it
We're
was so
fucking
bad.
Die, man.
It was so bad, dude. And after being so in love with Super Troopers, we were so excited.
Yep.
And like we were just like, this is the worst movie I've ever seen. Yep.
And in fairness, basically all the subsequent follow-ups to Super Troopers are mostly horrible.
I'll allow some Club Dread now. I've seen it
Beer
a few
Fest.
Times
beer it's starting to grow on me finally, but
I've never seen Beer Fest.
I saw it once back in the day.
Yeah. It's such a stark contrast between Super Troopers and everything else because there's a lot of like really dry, subtle, hilarious shit in Super Troopers, and then kind of everything thereafter is just very down the middle and not that great.
Was Balls of Fury one of theirs?
It was not one of theirs. I do have a soft spot for Balls of Fury.
I
got a soft spot for Balls of Fury.
So, you know?
It's low-rent Jack Black. I don't know what that guy's name is, but he's like a Bush League Jack Black.
Wish.com Jack Black.
Yeah, essentially. Dude. I'm going to give you two...
Oh, I know you're talking about, because he's in Fanboys, too. That Star Wars parody movie.
Never saw that.
Oh, you gotta, I don't know.
He's been in a handful of things.
You
got to
see that fucking movie. It's great.
I'm going to give you two submissions for the worst Stephen King adaptation ever made. Thinner. Have you seen Thinner?
I like Thinner.
Michael J. Fox, is it?
I don't think it was Jay. Maybe it was. Well, it's been a very long time since
I've
seen him.
No, that's Thinner, so I'm going to disagree with that one.
Frighteners is what I'm thinking of with Michael J. Fox.
Frighteners,
which is not,
I fucking
which is not
love,
Stephen King.
Dude.
That's a Peter Jackson movie. But
is it really Frighteners?
Yeah, that's early Peter Jackson.
Shit.
Yeah, yeah.
Pre
Lord of the Rings. Yeah.
I fucking love me some Frighteners. Yeah,
I actually
have
never
love
seen
that.
Yeah, but
the worst.
Okay,
the
I
worst.
Which one's the worst? Let's see if we agree.
There's almost no question. It's Maximum Overdrive. Have you seen Maximum Overdrive?
Have you
bro?
Seen The Mist?
I heard The Mist is good. Is it terrible?
That was it. Was it a TV miniseries?
No, I don't think so. It's a movie.
I'm not gonna ruin it. Thank you.
Fucking let's talk about Maximum Overdrive for a minute. Okay, so first of all, Maximum Overdrive is a movie that's actually literally directed by Stephen King.
His first and only.
First and only. It's the only time he ever tried.
Interjection here. No, they asked him, they were like, Stephen, are you ever going to direct another movie again? He's like, no. And they go, why? And he's like, did you see Maximum Overdrive? Shout out Stephen King.
It's got the fucking semi with the Joker mask thing on the
it's
front.
It's the most preposterous plot ever made, and it's like dead serious. It's not some kitschy, like Evil Dead type thing. It's absolutely trying to be good, and it absolutely falls on its face. It's Emilio Estevez, bro.
That's right.
It's of Mighty Ducks fame.
I've only seen
it's Coach
like,
Gordon Bombay.
I've never watched the whole thing. Oh man, that's a fucking candidate for the fucking. I didn't even think of that one, but that's a candidate for the Halloween thing, dude. I didn't even think about Maximum
Mighty Ducks.
Overdrive.
Oh, no, Maximum Overdrive.
Also, Mighty Ducks.
Quack, quack.
Also, Mighty Ducks, bro.
It's Knuckle Puck time. By the way, there's a band called Knuckle Puck now, or I don't know what it is.
Yeah, they're
so
new age pop punk.
Yeah, I so love good. That name. Yeah, it's well played. Sorry.
I mean, fucking Maximum Overdrive fucking stinks in an incredible rip.
It stinks.
And that is the greatest quote of all time.
Did any of you ever see the Shining miniseries that Stephen King wrote himself?
Yeah, and I've been to that hotel. I got a t-shirt from that hotel.
Yeah.
So the hotel that it's where they shot it, where he saw and decided to write the story about where he got the idea, is that fucking, it's not the Overlook. I forget what it's called. The Stanton? Something. Sorry, I can't remember. Not where they shot the other movie, the actual, but they did shoot that there. We took a tour of it and shit. But the miniseries is good. The miniseries is tight. I liked it. Starring the guy from Wings.
It's funny because it's rated guy one of the worst things that ever has come out for screen adaptations.
I thought it was dope. I mean, it's a fucking TV, 90s TV.
Right.
You know, starring the guy from Wings, you know. Like, and that motherfucker fucking reads a bunch of Stephen King's audiobooks. Stephen Weber is his name because I'm super into audiobooks. So fucking... Yeah, so fucking he reads his shit, but I thought the adaptation was pretty good. I mean, if I watch it now, I'm sure the special effects are god awful. I'm sure, you know what I mean? Like, but it's still like you gotta look past that shit a little bit.
Steven Weber might have been the dude from Thinner, possibly.
That would make sense.
I was picturing this guy's you know, face. Think he is. I think he might be in there.
Yep.
Did you ever say your candidate for the worst Stephen
The Mist.
King
movie?
Oh, The Mist, yeah.
Yeah.
And, The Mist was good. I have to check it out. What's terrible about it?
Oh, just it's the worst ending.
Was Tommy Lee Jones in The Mist?
Nah, I don't think so.
No, I think maybe. It was fucking, what's if, the guy's
he
name?
That's U.S. Marshals you're thinking of.
You're thinking of The Fugitive, actually.
Same fucking movie.
The Men prequel, in Black is the, what you're thinking
the prequel
of.
To U.S. Marshals.
The Fugitive, and then they made U.S. Marshals right. afterward, yeah.
Oh, Thomas Jane, yeah. I saw this way yeah. back.
The poor man's...
Thomas Jane shows. Poor man Simon Thomas Jones, Jane's
dude. You're right, dude. Some other... Tommy Lee Jane's, dude.
Jeffrey DeMunn, who is thoroughly inappropriate. You'll absolutely recognize his face, but not his name. Inappropriate, dude.
Fucking A. You guys following any other new Stephen King shit? You checking out any of his new books or any of that shit? Following Stephen King? I'm pretty up on catching most things Stephen King is doing.
Yeah.
It's pretty choice. His writing's fucking kind of, it's better than ever in some ways and worse than ever in some ways. He keeps, like, his dialogue can be like, he fucking writes like everybody talks like fucking Leave It to Beaver still.
Did you see the Welcome to Derry?
No.
That's going to be good,
I'm
think.
I'm sure, yeah. I mean, Derry takes place in a lot of his novels.
It's the first, it's all the It story.
Yeah, it's the big one, but Derry plays in a bunch of his shit.
What do you guys think of the new It remakes, 1 and 2?
Solid.
I thought they were solid.
I didn't see number 2. I only saw the first one.
I thought the second one was kind of trash, and I'm doing a 180 on this. So I've said many times my favorite horror movie is probably Scream, and was a huge fan of like mixing the comedy in, but nowadays, baby, I want my horror to be fucking devastating, keep the comedy factor out of it. No, thank you. I was going... Oh, the first It... one hit of weed and I'm toast, dude. The first It I thought was fucking dominant, dude. I love that first It remake. Cool. Second one...
Cool. Yeah. I didn't finish it. I need to see the second one, which is stupid. Like, I saw the first one in the theater. Never even saw the second one.
It's way, like, more kitschy and they're trying to be real cute with it and stuff. Where the
really?
First one... Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
That's
I
no.
kind of did
first
not
one's
dig
a kid. That's the second one's the adults, right?
Yeah. Yeah. You guys ever seen, I'm straight, you ever seen the It fucking miniseries though from the day, from the fucking 90s, the original with
Tim Curry?
Tim Curry as Pennywise?
Yeah.
Talking about the worst thing ever made. That might literally be the worst thing fucking ever made. Fucking Evans had a 2 VHS like box set. On, it was like it had the case, the double VHS box set and shit.
Yeah.
And it's the worst. I mean, again, it's hard to fucking adapt that shit, and especially at that time, but Jesus Christ, it's so bad, dude.
I don't get this. I disagree. Like, conceptually, it seems like it's hard to adapt because everybody shits the bed when they try to do it, but maybe they're just not getting good people to adapt it. Like, it's not
there's some
that
of that.
Hard
I mean, Mike Flanagan's had success, but he also chooses it fucking, you know, like wisely.
Right.
Well, so much of Stephen King, though, is like you picturing it in your head. Like a lot of it is like this like weird psychological, like it's in your mind. And then when you like put it into visual on the screen in front of you, it doesn't have the same effect as like
yes,
you
and,
picturing
well,
it in your fucking dome.
There's something to be said for that. But that inherently is the task of the director is to bring the conceptual to life in a way
but even,
that makes it choice.
Even
so again,
no matter how well you
there's...
do it, though, it's the fact that it now exists in the real world and you're watching it as opposed to it being in your mind. So it's like never as terrifying as your own interpretation in your own head.
It's a tough task to be sure.
Yeah, well, that's exactly right. Yeah, and it's so that's why it's tough. Fucking Stephen King. Also, Stephen King stinks.
The Stephen King book, I think it's called 1963. I talked about this before, yeah. But it's whatever year Kennedy was assassinated. Mm-hmm. Where it's this whole thing about, like, there's this time portal, go back and try and stop
James
Oswald,
Franco right? was involved.
That was actually good.
Yeah, no, he's in
what
the,
you're
yeah.
talking about.
See, that was, I was going to break your balls for being the book's always better than the movie guy, because it's an inherently...
I didn't love that Stephen King book. It was not one of my favorites.
See, I loved the book, and then I tried to watch the Franco, and I'm a fan of Franco, but I watched one episode. I'm like, yeah, I can't do
it. I never saw it. I never even watched it. What? That's exactly. It's hard. It's hard to fucking.
That book's dominant, by the way.
I liked it. It's not my favorite Stephen King book. It's
super good, though.
It's not bad. I'm just saying it's not my favorite Stephen King book. Mm-hmm. That's all. Mm-hmm. That's all.
Yeah.
Yeah, no, Stephen King sucks. He's got some new shit fucking, it's called Holly. I don't know if you guys caught that at all. It's fucking really good. It's one of his new characters he's been working with for a while. Did you catch that? There was a miniseries called The Outsider on HBO.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Holly's one of the characters in that, but she's in other things which have also been adopted. I don't know if you ever caught Mr. Mercedes, which was a TV show.
No.
The Bill Hodges trilogy, etc.
I gotta tell you, The Outsider was very promising. The first like 2-ish episodes of that were dominant, and then I thought it kind of fell off.
The series did a little bit, and again, it's hard to like fucking portray that fucking sense of dread that like the book has, you know, like. So the character in that show, she's like the black girl with the dreads. But this character Holly, he's been fucking doing this probably 5 or 6 like Holly stories and all. It's pretty good shit. Just check it out. You guys into fucking any audiobooks going on there, Jakey Jake? We fucking you were pretty
no,
deep into
I haven't
fantasy
had a
there.
Chance to get into anything lately. Really, I've just been working on recording and learning how to record again. And do it all by myself.
Yeah,
you know that whole fucking process.
Yep. Yep.
Learning how to mix by yourself, learning how to master for the first time. Trying to not suck.
Trying to do Post Malone covers.
Yep. And honestly, I'm still so fucking pissed off about Patrick Rothfuss not ever releasing anything that I'm just tired of. Almost has ruined me on like waiting for a series of books. Yeah. So if there's a full series out, I might dig back into something, but if there's anything new coming out, I don't know that I'm going to give a shit until it's all done.
You were balls deep into that Rothfuss.
Between Rothfuss and like George Martin never finishing the actual books.
Yeah, he's out. Dude, he don't give a shit.
I know, exactly. And that's...
He's done.
It's just annoying to me.
I kind of get it on his part. I can kind of see his perspective.
No, his money's
like,
been made. The story was finished.
The story's finished. He's like, I don't...
Yeah, but the story was finished terribly.
Well,
everybody says, and everybody, like, even people that are diehard fans of that show.
My favorite
are all
part
disappointed
was the Dasani
the
bottle, dude. The Dasani water bottle. The
Starbucks cup.
Yeah, right, exactly. I remember, but the first time you were on the podcast, and I'm going to call you out about this every single time, you were going off about how Patrick Rothfuss is the American soul, dude. Which, to be fair, we all are. Now, those stories are pretty good, but it is ridiculous. How is this guy, at that time, it had been too long? That was 2 years ago we were talking about it.
It's been 13 years.
Like, how? How is this guy not written this? You have one job. Yeah. Like, sit down and write your stupid fucking fantasy story that we were all geeking out on for a minute. Also, you had the momentum.
Mm-hmm.
You know, he had a fucking, you know, people on prominent podcasts were saying that he was the American like Tolkien. You know what I'm saying? And like, you're not going to fucking follow it up, dude. Like, it's ridiculous. I know apparently he's had some health issues or something. That might be bullshit.
Yeah,
I think
some
it's
health
bullshit.
Issues. He had a kid and then he also did
Call
a bunch
bullshit.
Of other like, he just got into board
Call
gaming.
Bullshit.
And
it stinks. It stinks. Yeah.
It
Fuck
does.
That guy.
It fucking
it stinks. It stinks. Because fucking like Joe Abercrombie is still fucking crapping out amazing books, dude. Fucking great shit. It's not as good as the original, but it's still great. It's great. It's great shit. I loved it too.
All three of those trilogies were
fun. I loved it. Right? Loved it. Great shit.
Are you all caught up on his shit?
Fuck yeah, dude. I'm catching it immediately when that comes on. I'm a huge fan. He's. Yep. Have you caught, though, have you caught Red Rising?
No.
Bro.
You know, I've got.
Here's my review. Wait, let me give you my review of Red Rising.
Okay.
Bro.
You gotta get deep with it too.
That's the review. Bro. No, that's it. That's the review.
That's all you need.
Bro.
Bruh. You need to check it out. It's fucking Game of Thrones in space.
Game of Thrones in
space.
That's a pretty huge pitch right there.
It's fucking the writing itself is phenomenal. It's fucking just like anybody can die at any minute. You know what I mean? You're just reading along, then all of a sudden, and this guy's head gets cut off. You're just like, what? This is the main character. What are you talking about? It's fucking, it's fantastic. Who's this cat again? This is a dude named Pierce Brown.
Okay.
Red Rising is the name of the series. He just dropped, that's the first book. He just dropped, like a month ago, the latest in the series, book like 6. And then the next one's going to be like the last one in the series, I think. But
is it like in the future it takes place?
Oh, yeah. It takes place 1,000 years in the future.
Okay.
It takes place fucking. It's basically, he describes it as classical, like Roman and Greek shit mixed with futuristic. So it's like, and it's like the whole fucking, it's fucking wild. Everybody, the whole humanity is cast into like all these different fucking, it's like a pyramid of different kinds of people, and the golds are on top and the reds are on bottom.
Yada yada. It's a classism in the future. Yes, we get it.
You get it.
We get it.
I said the first book, I literally feel like he was like, he read The Hunger Games and was like, I'm going to write The Hunger Games book good. That's what I feel like he was doing. That's when he like wrote this shit. But I fucking love it. I'm super fucking into it. Red Rising's fucking badass. Even fucking checked it out.
Did you ever see, speaking of like class type things, so Netflix did this movie, I forget what it was called, I have to look it up, but it's about like this prison system essentially, and everybody's on a different level. And the people on the highest level,
starring Stallone,
get like this dominant food, get this four course food, like whatever, and then whatever you don't eat trickles down to the next group. Have you seen this?
Is
Have
it starring Stallone?
This? No, but it should be. Yeah. It'd be much choicer for what did.
No, it's, I don't know.
That. Awesome, dude.
That's pretty much Red Rising. Yeah, no, sounds about right. It's pretty dominant. What are you fucking doing over there?
I just bought the book.
Oh, nice. Okay. Like balls deep under here. Fair enough. I'll allow that. What the fuck happened to Jake, dude? He fucking other Jake.
Tapping out. Tap out for a second.
All right, maybe we should take a break because somebody just left. Apparently,
the opening literally goes like, "This is not anything I'm interested in talking." Come hither, children. I'll tell you a tale.
That should be the intro to every podcast, dude. He's going through all my guitars right now. The podcast is going astray.
Yep.
It's all guitars. It's the guitar cast. Well, I'll tell you the fucking story of the fucking fretless, dude. I probably told this on here before. I went to see the band Sons of Apollo. Starring, get that mic, get your mic. Starring,
what if I don't want to get the mic?
Starring Mike Portnoy.
No, it's a Mike fucking, Portnoy
yeah,
band.
Yeah, and fucking Derek Sherinian of Dream Theater fame. And fucking, it's fucking Derek, Jesus Christ, what the fuck is, I'm spacing on the bass player. Let's see. I'm fucking this all up. I'm fucked up. And then fucking Bumblefoot on guitar. Do you guys know who Bumblefoot is?
Sounds like me when I drink too much.
Yo, just Bumblefoot.
Falling all over the fucking place.
So Bumblefoot is one of these fucking like shred master like solo guitarists, right? But he's also very famous for being the lead guitarist in the post / Guns N' Roses.
Okay.
So anyway, he's also in this band. It's fucking Bumblefoot, Mike Portnoy, Derek Sherinian, the bass player who's arguably the fucking best guy whose name escapes me, and fucking and they both play fucking double necks, and the fucking top is the fretless, so the bassist and guitarist are both playing double neck guitars fucking fretless on top.
If you're playing fucking a single neck at this point, kind of a bitch. That's kind of a bitch made mood. Anything less than two necks.
And bro, let me tell you, fucking, well, I was there and fucking with Nick Hagen was there. We were fucking at this. It was at the intersection down here, you know, we're checking out fucking Portnoy's fucking band. It's like a Wednesday night. Nobody's
watching
there.
Portnoy snugging up on a Wednesday.
And fucking
standard fare.
So quite anyway, standard, really. Fucking Bumblefoot dominates on this fucking fretless guitar, dude. Absolutely fucking unbelievable. Like, I've never seen anything like it. You know, like, it's on a fretless. How hard was that to play?
Impossible.
It's impossible, dude. And he's just killing it. Riffs, not just solos and shit. Riffs, like, song, you know, like, just crushing on this fucking thing. And so I'm fucking high as hell, right? And I'm fucking
on warm up building a guitar.
Yeah, so, well, I fucking text my brother that night. I text him, "Hey man, I gotta build a fretless Strat." Like, listen, this has to happen. And fucking, so I call
him. Still
not day.
This gourd flying in the wings of Bumblefoot.
Seriously, dude. I fucking go on to start buying the parts, right? I'm fucking sourcing. It's a cheap ass guitar, honestly. The next piece of shit, like the fucking the mirror pick guard, which looks very cool. It's a preloaded. Those pickups are garbage.
Oh, yeah.
Garbage. I would like to replace them at some point, but you know, but still, like, so I piece it all together, and my fucking brother, like, shout out to him, fucking puts it, he actually put that guitar together for me, fucking set it up and whatever. Hey, you know, you gotta like file the nut way down. That neck is meant to be fretted.
So you have to file the nut super down, super hard.
Yeah,
you have
because
to really gotta file drop the bridge nut. Way down and
really file that
really
nut.
Gotta
file that nut.
File that nut, baby.
Nah, dude, give me a couple hours with that fucking thing and I'd probably be able to rip.
You can borrow it, dude. Take it home with you, man. Shit, borrow for a couple weeks, dude. Come back with something good and let's
record. Somebody's gotta get sweet
on
fret.
Seriously.
One of you motherfuckers gotta learn how to play.
Did we tell you the story yet?
Oh, we met. We actually had a phone conversation with Keith Urban.
Really?
Yeah.
Directly?
Directly.
Like actually, ooh, really?
So we were playing down in Saugatuck at Saugatuck Brewing Company, and we got off stage, and a guy walks up and hands me $100, and he's just like, "That's for you guys." And just like,
nice.
Then he just starts making conversation.
You had to blow this guy later, though.
Oh, yeah. Starts making conversation. He's like, "Do you guys know any Keith Urban?" I'm like, "No, I don't. I wonder if my buddy does."
The video's going to look better on your phone.
And I'll show you the video when we're on break later, or when we're done.
So insert the video here.
Insert. So, turns out he knows a song.
Well, when I was in the band with my dad, we covered a Keith Urban song that was.
You said you were going to try to start learning more
some
country.
Some days you got to dance by. Yeah.
But
Keith
that actually
Urban.
Turns out it's by the Dixie Chicks.
Yeah, it's the Dixie Chicks.
Oh. No,
side
sorry.
Note,
it's
you
just
gotta
the
appreciate
chicks.
The irony of a fuck guy named Urban who's in the country music.
Who's also not who's also not American.
That's good.
Is he Australian?
He's New Zealander.
Isn't he fucking, what's her face? Fucking Nicole Kidman?
Yes.
Is that that guy or whatever?
Yes.
Okay, all right.
Is he really? Well played, yeah. Keith Urban.
I've been together for a long time.
Well done,
so it turned out he knew a song, so we played it in the middle of that set.
Listen,
and
he says, so we played it. We walked outside on our break. I played the first 30 seconds of this song he'd never heard before.
Yeah. I'd never heard it.
I'd never played it. I sang it at karaoke one time 6 years ago. Like, this was not practiced.
Yeah, poorly.
The guy sitting there with, you know, a couple of, one younger kid and two women. And he's got his phone up recording us the whole fucking time while we're doing it, right? And we went on break, I don't know, half an hour later or whatever. And he says, "Oh, yeah, I sent that that video that I was recording to Keith." I'm like, "Fucking what? What do you mean you sent it to him? Like, you tagged him on Twitter or something like that?" And No. I
we received a strongly worded cease and desist moments later.
His son played in a golf tournament. His son wanted to be a professional golfer. So he played in a golf tournament, like a celebrity one, with Keith Urban as his fucking partner.
Nice.
And this guy is a businessman of some sort.
He's
wealthy. He spends. He
was
lives
he
in.
Was he Australian?
He goes,
no.
He was, like, he goes, look.
He lives in Chicago and spends his weekends up
he
in.
He turns his phone around. It's a picture of him. And he goes, "That's me. That's my wife right there." And he's sitting across from his wife, who, you know, 40 years is younger. And looks great. And that's Keith. And that's Nicole, by first name, you know, fucking asshole, in front of my jet.
Nice.
And he's doing that.
And that man is Elon Musk. Cool. So then what? He fucking calls him? Why'd you guys talk about football?
Yeah, he just called him. He on his own accord just decided, oh, I'm going to call him really quick and see what he had to think about it.
He's fucking swinging
dick. Keith texted him back and said something like, oh, yeah.
Oh, that's cool.
After he texted it to him, he said, oh, yeah, I'll record a reaction video.
This guy's been plotting this for weeks before. He's like, hey, Bob, I got this whole thing I want to do.
You get the reaction video?
I've got a reaction video.
What the fuck, really?
Yeah,
that's dope. Yeah, dude.
And then we get up back on stage after that and playing a song, and song gets over. The guy walks up and says, "Here," and fucking shows the phone, and
he's got Keith Urban on the phone.
Keith Urban's on the fucking phone.
That's fucking awesome. That's awesome. So what'd he say?
He was just like, "Hey, you guys are doing great. What are you planning on playing next? Like something like that."
Apparently, nothing but Keith Urban from now on.
So now we're actually recording a song.
He,
so that
he throws another $100 in there and says, "That's from Keith."
Nice.
So we had
we got tipped by Keith Urban.
That was a decent tip.
Nice.
It's like, hey, this is Keith Urban. I've heard better, but keep on keeping on, guys.
Keep trying, though. You guys are okay.
I was like, I'm sorry, fucking I badass. Butchered that's your awesome. Song, man.
Nice. Dude.
He apologized to Keith Urban.
She'd been like, you know, I'm more of a Tom Cruise fan than myself, actually. No, that is...
Pretty.
Jesus Christ, that song is long. That's fucking dope as fuck, though. That's cool as hell, man. Talk to Keith Urban, yeah.
So, yeah, now we're recording a...
A better version of it that doesn't... That's now that we both know the song.
What's the song?
We're doing You'll Think of Me.
Yeah, You'll Think of Me.
Okay, I'm not up on my Keith Urban tunes.
It's one that nobody's ever covered, so we figured that would be a good choice, on top of it being the one that we did.
It's pretty impressive, but I'm holding out for that Nicole Kidman reaction video. Bro.
That's what I'm saying.
Indeed, dude. Yeah.
We were going to ask him to just put Nicole on the phone.
Yeah. That's what I'm saying, dude.
We'll request that, because he's got the number for the guy that...
I've got the number for the son.
For the son.
Right.
So we're going to talk to him about that
later. Yeah, we're
going to
communicate it.
Can you get Keith Urban on this podcast? That's something we can make happen, dude.
He's tried to get on. I'm not really interested, dude.
We got bigger fish to fry.
I'm like, you bring Nicole, we'll talk, dude.
We got prestigious guests like my brother and others that have been on here.
Like Wood.
I wanted to get my brother on.
Our homies.
That was fun. We got to give you a shout out, baby, bro. It's choice combo.
You brought him tonight, dude.
Jayk versus Jayk is our normal acoustic duo shit.
Yeah. But they're doing a full band now.
Our full band thing is... right now, it's just three of us. We're working for
Jayk versus Jayk versus Jayk.
Just called Versus.
It's just called Versus. But my brother, I want
to feel like
him
you
to talk
need to fucking have another Jayk in the band, guys.
I don't have a brother named Jayk. So.
Yeah, but what if he just kind of like goes by Jayk?
His name's Emilio.
That's a dope name, actually. Your brother's Emilio. He's your older brother?
Yeah.
Cool. He's the drummer, right?
He is. Yeah. He's fucking
somebody,
great.
One of you guys, I'm not sure which one, sent me like a picture of like his spot. He's got a pretty killer fucking drummer room and shit, right?
He's got a killer spot.
Yeah, it looked fucking badass. It was also like awesomely like Mexican, too. It was kind of like Adobe-ish or something, right?
He's Mexican Puerto Rican.
Yeah. Yeah, it's fucking
but
cool.
Yeah, I wanted you guys to fucking talk drums.
Yeah, man. I'd love to fucking meet your brother. And that spot looked dope as fuck, man. Yeah.
Just bring you out there.
Let's go. I know. I've been trying. Well, fucking, I'm trying to do, well, we'll see. Fucking, I want to do like studio tours, like other
cool
people's studios, you know.
Yeah.
Well, certainly not original, you know, but like around here, you know, just local. Like, so that would be fucking fun. Go out there and fucking beat on some drums, talk shit with your brother. Like, hey, Jayk, nice to meet you. My name's Emilio. Yeah, nice to meet you, Jayk. Jayk versus Jayk.
Just belligerent as shit.
So is that the fucking next tune you're going to do then? Is the Keith Urban thing?
Yep,
we've got a few of them in the fire right now. We've got ten in the works right now.
Yeah.
One of which being The Weeknd. The ever popular Friday, Saturday, Sunday. Just Blinding Lights.
Yeah, maybe don't. Maybe do a different
one. I'm trying to
that
find...
That played.
Yeah, I want to find another one that's not, like, Creepin',
so
though. Creepin' is a fucking terrible song.
I'll give you some ideas.
I'm a huge fan of Earned It.
I don't even know.
That I'm song. Open to it because that
one was movie the 50 fan. Shades song.
Oh yes, I'm a little later. I'm a little later on my fucking. I'm more of a yeah. Starboy guy, then you know, on yeah. the fucking new shit. You know, should do Starboy.
My dude. My kid is Orion. Is his first name. He calls himself Starboy. That's all of his fucking his like PlayStation gamer tag.
Well, that makes sense.
Starboy.
Yeah. That makes
he's
a lot of sense.
He's also a bass player.
A fucking
wait, is this the newborn? Wait, I'm
the yeah, newborn's a bass player.
I'm like, what? What, sir? What's your newborn?
You should see that kid dominate a fretless for a 3-week old. It's incredible.
Uh-huh. Orion, Harlow, and Osiris.
Osiris. That's sorry. Yeah, yeah, Orion. Those are fucking great names, dude.
Thanks.
Excellent. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Love that alliteration yeah. with Osiris and Orion mm-hmm. being.
No, I get it.
Orion. Ortiz.
Oh, yeah. Uh-huh.
Orion, Ortiz, Osiris. Ortiz.
Yeah.
Ozzy is what we're doing.
The, okay. The I like that, too. Osiris. Yeah. That's nice. That's nice. I like those names. There's a fucking. Guys, I don't know if you fucking guys you have fallen this, but.
Kid.
Right.
There's a fucking lot of shitty fucking names out there for babies right now, dude, that are just like. Awful.
His name's
dude.
Osiris Atreyu.
And what? So what is actually Atreyu besides the band? I mean, that's...
He was the hero character in the Neverending Story.
Okay, yes. Yes, got it.
That's a deep cut right there. Mm-hmm. That's well played, so...
I never really, like, was a big Neverending Story fan. Like, I never really watched it a lot as a kid or something. I don't have that, like, connection yeah. to it.
Neverending Story is just...
Is it...
I don't remember it, but I remember loving it back in the day. That came out very, very long time.
Yeah, I think it was 86.
It was a young-ass book.
Yeah, yeah.
87, something like that.
That was one that, like, you know, like, you kind of, like, had certain movies when you were a kid that, like, you kind of got attached to or whatever. Like, I don't know. I never got attached to that
84 was the first Neverending Story.
So that was fucking 10 years before yours was even born.
Three.
Oh, yeah, I thought you guys are younger than you.
36.
Fucking old-ass fucking men over here. 84 is the year I was born. Probably you, too.
Yes, sir.
Right? Yeah.
Shout out. What?
Damn. You guys ever see Flight of the Navigator?
Yeah.
I don't think I saw that one. What's that?
The greatest movie of all time.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. It is a...
Added to the list.
A kid who ends up in a fucking spaceship, and the spaceship is fucking voiced by Paul Rubens. A Pee Wee Herman
fuck
fame.
Yeah,
it is fantastic. And I'll tell... Some other time. Maybe I'll allude to it right
Rotten
now.
Rotten Tomatoes says it's an 84% fresh movie. So
yeah,
that's,
that makes sense.
That's respectable.
There's a story. Remind me some other time when like Rick Beam or Josh or somebody of that crew is here to tell the Flight of the Navigator
Trimaxian.
Story.
I vaguely remember this shit. I gotta catch it. It's Sarah it's Jessica terrible. Parker.
Oh, really?
Your girl,
I don't remember
SJP
that. My girl?
As well.
I don't like her
your
at
girl.
All.
Your girl.
I'm not a fan of fucking
talking to Howard Hesserman, Abel Hesserman.
Nah. Nah.
When Family Guy said Sarah Jessica Parker,
she looks like a foot.
Like it hit so hard.
So well played.
She looks like a foot.
They really let her have it, dude. Yeah. South Park had that whole thread with Sarah Jessica Parker. Dude,
I don't
really
remember
catches.
That. What did they do with her?
I think. It was some horse face material or some shit.
Sense.
I don't know. They were doing
a
whole.
She's got horse face.
Oh, no. The
dude.
Whole episode is they were ripping on
no
her.
No shit.
And then they were like,
she's got horse
there's
face.
There's got to be some reason for this. And like, no, it's just funny to make fun of Sarah Jessica Parker. She's just ugly. She's just not attractive. It's as simple as that.
You guys ever watch Sex in the City? You ever see it at all?
Fuck, that's awesome.
Nah, is it? I heard it's good. I know.
I mean,
I know guy friends that are like, it's a fucking great show. I mean, it's early HBO. It set the tone for a lot of HBO
I
stuff.
I was
you know?
Always a huge fan of the whore. I forgot what her fucking name is.
Kim Cattrall.
Oh, Kim Cattrall.
I think it was Kim Cattrall's character. Yeah.
Talking about fucking Police Academy, boys.
She was just... She
Police
was fucking,
Academy.
She was aware of who she was, and she fucking went with it.
Yeah,
and that
Cattrall's
was
show.
Like, I love that kind of a character. Who knows what
described.
She wants and goes for it.
This was a dark-haired chick that was the fucking babe. I don't even know who it is.
But. She's still in stuff. I don't know her name.
Well, they're she's doing more things. Sex in the mm-hmm. City.
Yeah,
you know, like I don't know what the
shit
is,
now.
But like, and I know Kim Cattrall was not in the first reboot, but she's coming back now or something, is what I hear.
So. Good.
Yeah.
What's the story behind that? Why was she not in the
I know,
the
like, reboot? What else are you doing, Kim
they
Cattrall?
Didn't pair enough.
Probably, okay.
You know, yeah, you're probably right.
Either that or, you know, she didn't want to be a whore.
She could get naked.
Right.
The other girl was fucking running for mayor of New York or some
really?
Shit. I'm talking,
whoa,
yeah.
No shit.
The one
the
we haven't talked about, the kind of red haired. Yeah.
The least attractive one.
Hey.
Those goddamn gingers. Hey,
easy,
you know?
Easy.
I've yet to see a good looking ginger.
I know. No, she's that's painfully Rain unattractive. Mary, but
Cynthia Nixon Marie, is that one.
There you go, yes.
Kristen Davis played Charlotte.
Okay. Yeah, I don't know. Not up on that. But then they made fucking Entourage, which is one of the greatest shows ever.
That's
which
what
is
I was
going
to say.
Yeah.
Smith once referred to Entourage as Sex and the City for men.
Yes, they're like, well, Sex and the City worked, so we're going to make a version of that for dudes.
Oh, I always thought that was Entourage.
I never saw it. Oz, wait, isn't that the prison show? Getting fucking ass raped.
Exactly.
I'm going back through Oz.
Sex in the inner city. Like, that's what really happened.
Sex in the cell block. I never watched that.
Oz is dominant. I'm going back through it again right now. It's fucking choice, dude.
Starring also the other guy from The Matrix, the dude who played Link.
Yeah,
in
he's
there,
the
right?
guy that does all the intros to the show. Is also starring fucking Carl Winslow.
Carl Weathers?
Ghostbusters, bro.
Carl
Winslow. Fucking,
should be Carl Winslow.
Who's the dude from Ghostbusters here? Ernest.
Oh.
Fucking Ernest.
Ernie Hudson.
Ernie Hudson.
Yeah,
Ernest
wow,
Hudson.
Really? Yeah, I don't know. Oh, okay.
Nothing but.
Man, I gotta get some Oz, dude.
Oz is choice. Dude. All right. Edie Falco as well.
Really?
Christopher Maloney, dude. Tons of cameos in this.
Okay.
Oz is
I just dug in deep
show.
For you and bought all six of those Pierce Brown books. Just
wow.
Might as well have just done
it's
it.
All you've been doing is not saying a goddamn word on the podcast.
In 10 minutes.
Just
fucking
deep diving on Pierce Brown, Red Rising. You heard it here. Red Rising fucking owns. I can't believe they haven't fucking made a movie of it yet, but it's coming and it's gonna be fucking incredible, or it's gonna be awful, but the books are fucking great. You heard it here first. Red Rising owns. Fuck you guys. No, yeah, it's no, I'm telling you, it's really good.
Smash!
Oh, fuck,
smash!
The elusive Kai sound.
That's what I was trying to do.
I've been waiting for Kai this whole time.
You gotta have it, dude.
Yeah, Red Rising's great.
It stinks.
Yeah. Dude, Patrick Rothfuss is probably American's.
Dang. It. Dang.
Cat's back.
Oh, Jesus Christ. So here's what I'm thinking. Can we play the song on the outro of the episode here? The fucking the cover, you guys?
Yeah, man.
I don't have it here queued up, but I'll just fucking fly it in and we'll fucking lay it out on the rest of the fucking show. So
just play it on my phone and stick my phone.
Yeah, stick it up to the microphone. Yeah. Speaking to the mic, bitch. Any fucking things you guys want to plug? So this fucking Jayk versus Jayk. Where's the song available? It's out, right?
It's on Bandcamp. Well, it's out on all streaming platforms, but there's a remixed version of it, the one that you've heard on Bandcamp.
Yeah, I lost track of the fucking versions, dude.
I know. I made
after version 16, I was like, it's getting worse. What is happening, dude? You had it. It's good. No, it's a super fun cover, and you fucking singing the shit out of that song, dude. It sounds real good. Fucking bass is cool, fucking drums are cool. I liked it. So you can look up
the
Jayk versus Jayk.
Super cool.
So
the way he does the drums.
Did you guys have
super
somebody
cool.
record it? Like, was it? Because I know you were doing the e drums.
So I did a whole the e drums drum pack thing, and then I sat down with our drummer and had him play through the song with me a billion times and go through and do all of his fills the way he wanted to do them, and I just wrote him in. As it was easier than converting his electric kit and doing
all
that.
Oh, you just doing it on like the
I think it was easier for me to write it
he
in than it would be for him
times.
To.
Yeah.
Him doing what? That is the most impressive shit I've seen. I mean, like, I don't know how to make drum beats very well on a fucking on a laptop or whatever. But he just click, 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 click.
Yeah,
play it's that not, again. Click, click, click.
And I don't mean this in a bad way. It's not hard. You could learn it. Yeah. It's just like,
as long as you understand how a time scale works.
Yeah. It's just,
it's like, that's my life's work.
The way he did it.
No, it's not.
And the amount of time. I mean, we knocked out an entire song on, like, of just drum fills and solos and shit like that.
Yeah.
In 2 hours?
Yeah, it's the same as, like, I felt like it took about the same amount of time as going in and tracking real drums, miking them up, getting all the sounds, getting all that shit done right.
It seems like that would take so much longer.
We did it in two sessions. We did it in two sessions of, like, 3 hours a piece.
Suck it, Danny Carey.
That's the point of electronic drums, is that it's super fucking easy and you can fix everything.
Well, and nowadays, if you understand and you treat them like they're raw tracks.
Yeah.
Then, like, you separate all the drums out separately and treat them like they're all tracks. It comes out really good.
Yeah. Okay, so you didn't actually, because the way you were talking, I thought maybe, I know you did that, and then I thought maybe you went back in and actually recorded a real drummer and then like flew those
no,
in.
No, I didn't end up doing that. I thought about it, but there's, I don't know. I just found it easier to do it the way that I did it.
Well, of course, yeah. Super fucking easy. What kind of, not to get super nerdy here, but what kind of fucking sample packs?
Giga drums. They're modern and massive. They're modern and massive kick.
Yeah, Giga stuff's great. I didn't love the interface.
No, I don't love it either, but what I did was I just made 8 separate instances, one for each drum, and called it good.
Right. Okay. Yeah, sure.
And then just made a separate one and just turned everything off except for overheads and turned everything off except for room.
His samples are fucking great.
The samples are great,
And I mean, he's the fucking man.
For real. Yeah. I was using Slate for a while back in the day, but Get Good's way better.
Yeah. I'm still on fucking like Superior. I still use a lot of that shit.
Superior makes great shit, man.
I mean, they were kind of the original in some ways. Yeah.
So it's kind of like Lion 6 with digital amplification kind of thing.
Yeah.
They have to be good at it to still be in the game.
Right. Which Lion 6 is not.
Yeah, they are.
Well, they are now.
The Helix stuff is incredible.
I don't know about incredible. They're kind of my least favorite of all that stuff.
Well, then all the guitar tones that are in that track are Helix native, so.
Yeah, no, that's fine. No, it sounds like shit. It's fine.
Great. Perfect.
Have you guys...
That's what I was going for.
I was trying to end the podcast, but now I'm getting fucking nerdy. Have you seen the new Fender?
Yes. I'm impressed by all of the Fender bits of it. I don't know how I feel about the other amps that they made.
Like metal?
Yeah. And it looks like a Helix.
Well, it's super
similar
to
the same buttons. They use the same scribble strips. They use
the quad cortex. Yeah, it's very similar to that one. Which, I mean, to be fair, it's all going to format itself into some very... I mean, there's only so much you can do, you know? Like, it's all going to work out into a thing that makes sense, you know?
So Helix just did a huge update, which made everything way better. It almost made IRs obsolete for them. And Helix 2 is coming out next year.
Here's another thing about the Helix stuff. Is the actual hardware. I have two fucking good friends who use Helixes, and they were both shitting the bed. The hardware.
Ours has been working fine, except for one of the buttons.
Well, guess what? One of the buttons fucking counts hard. It should not be
wrong.
It should not be fucking...
The thing about it is, though, we're just fucking lazy, because Line 6... is very good about, they'll send you a loaner while they replace or fix yours.
That's fine. Good for them. I don't want a fucking loaner. It needs to be fucking working from the goddamn get-go. Because guess what? It's a super competitive thing now, especially. And again, you guys are supposed to be top of the line.
But
I feel the Line 6 stuff is not top of the line.
User interface is top of the line, though.
That's cool. Yeah. I believe that. And that's important.
It is very important.
Really important. It's super important. Yeah. So fair enough. I kind of like the Boss stuff. I'm not a big fan of any of it.
Native.
I like amps that sound like shit and buzz and are hard to mic and it's a pain in the ass. That's what I do.
It reminds me of that email you sent to PRS the other day. We got an email back from PRS that said, can buy replacement pots on our website.
Yeah, great.
That was the whole fucking email that they sent back about my... $2,000 Silver Sky.
Did you send them your tattoo?
You guys owe me some shit seriously. At this point. Like,
You send me a guitar, guys. Yeah. Fucking A.
I didn't see that email.
Yeah, that's because I read it and we have an attached email. And when I read emails, you don't get them.
Yeah.
Well, you know, PRS, you know, it's just kind of dog shit. No, I'm kidding. I like to fuck with you because you got the tattoo. No, I like PRS. I'm just kidding around. All right, so we're going to play the fucking song, and we'll fucking do a little outro of the song here. Is there anything else you guys want to fucking pitch? Where are you guys playing?
We're at Trail Point Brewing tomorrow in Allendale for their Harvest Festival.
What you got coming up besides that? This will come out probably 3 days from now. So.
Okay.
Kirby Friday and...
Yeah, we're at the this Saturday. Upcoming week. We're at the Kirby House in
Green Haven
Friday. Yep, right. And then we're at Ironwood Bar and Grill in Walker on Saturday.
Wednesday, we're at Holiday.
Okay, you guys got gigs all the fucking time.
We're
2 or 3 days a week.
Check out the Facebook. It's got a calendar.
Doing work.
Jayk versus Jayk.
Jayk versus Jayk on fucking the Facebooks, the fucking
or the Instagrams,
the Twitters,
or the X.
Look them up on the X.
If you look us up on X, try not to judge me.
There's a link to our other social medias there. That's all it's good for.
Indeed. All right, boys. Fucking thank you guys for coming.
Thanks for having us.
We'll do a fucking deep dive on Red Rising the podcast next time.
I'm bringing guitars next time.
Yeah, we're bringing guitars next time.
It's going to be all guitar for 3 hours straight.
We're going to have a guitar nerd podcast.
All right, that sounds more like it. All right, peace, fellas.
Peace.
God damn it. Oxytocin making it all.